This program is rated MA. It contains adult themes, coarse language, sexual references, and violence.
Alright, what's up? Open comms, Friday night. We are back. People are saying push the buttons. Hopefully, the stream's working for me on my side, so I don't know, maybe you guys have to refresh. Who knows?
You can see it working?
Cause it's not. Yeah, working I see it working on my stream. Refresh. Yeah. Like, so, it worked. Anyway, I'm Drayden. Dirk's here. What's up, Dirk?
What's going on?
What's happening? How's it going? Rain, how's it going, Rain?
Good, how are you, Jayden?
I'm good.
Oh, God, my color is so shit, dude. It's like green all over it.
I'll fix it. Well, kind
what
of.
What the hell?
Dude, Chroma sucks in window capture.
Why do I have a green screen?
Well, you got, like, a puke stain on the back. Anyway, Drunk Canadian, what's up, man?
What's going on?
Not too much. And then LB LeBlanc back with us again. How's it going?
Good, how you doing?
All right. Let's start it up while I fix Dirk's color.
Do we want to give the shout-out first?
Well, geez,
shout-out.
Well, we might as well now that you've
done it. Yeah, you brought it up.
Shout-out to Lysis. Happy birthday, bro.
Should we do a shout-out for Lysis because it's his birthday?
If we start doing that, then we're going to have to like start demanding proof because everybody's going to go, hey, it's my birthday.
So, yeah. Lysis, I knew it was Lysis' birthday before he said because I have him on Skype and Skype does that obnoxious thing where it tells everyone it's your birthday.
Unless, you know, you changed your birthday in Skype and then you can make it every day.
I got Dirk fixed.
Like, stop being so technical.
Oh, God damn it. I guess I have to actually fix it.
Dirk looks so
bad. Nice. He went to, what'd you do, go to the black? Okay, just leave me like that.
He looks so spooky, Dirk.
Oh, yeah.
Spooky Dirk.
Oh, my God. Yeah, oh, you can do a shout for Lysis.
Then I think Nana just subscribed. We can do it to both of them.
All right, Nana Kalinski. Where is my hockey jersey, DC? Yeah, where the fuck is that hockey jersey?
Wait, am I supposed to be wearing my hockey jersey?
Apparently.
But it's in my car, and it's kind of sweaty because I played a lot of hockey today.
People aren't going to smell you on stream, man.
You all smell me.
Nana Kalinski for 11 months. Thank you.
All right, so...
Anyways, let's do the shot for Lysis. You know, happy birthday. Yeah, I don't know. What is he, 19 now or something?
He's at least 21.
You think? I don't know.
Yeah, so 22.
Why? Because you've seen him drink?
Yeah, Vegas.
Yeah, well, we had a 19-year-old drink it. No, I don't think we... I think he actually just turned 21. Maybe he's 20.
He looked like a little kid.
We kind of committed the distribution of minors on air a couple years ago.
But so, for reals, I don't know if anybody else has a birthday out there and wants to send your birth certificate to actually prove it. Let us know. Also, I don't know. We should probably take some I wish we had one of those things where people could call in.
Well, we have a TeamSpeak server.
Is my color still messed up out there?
It's as good as it's going to get with the window capture.
It's as good as it's going to get with a green lower half. You know what it looks like? It looks like sky above grass.
Well, yeah, you're in
sort
a field.
Which the whole thing doesn't make any sense.
I'm telling you, OBS is Chroma for window capture as opposed to just direct camera sucks.
Are you using Studio or just regular OBS?
I'm using whatever the free one is.
He's using OB free.
Yeah.
OB Free Winobi.
It's my only hope.
Weird. Anyway.
This is terrible. It's like watching the freaking Meta Show where they can't chroma Mitani right.
Yeah. Well, I remember when Wiggles was on, he was telling me why the chroma capture doesn't work with window capture because it's not a direct feed from the camera. It's the feed from the camera being applied to a screen, which then, because the colors that I'm seeing from Skype apparently aren't as true of a color as like what your camera pulls in or something. I don't know. But
XSplit doesn't have a problem with it, so fuck it. I'm not going with that. You know what? Here, you guys talk about something. I'm taking my green screen down because I'm not going to have a shit version of a green screen. Why bother?
Can you send your green screen to me?
Derek, is that a true gamer? He can't do a
green
screen?
It's just the shadow,
properly?
Derek. It chromas out. It's just if you can find a way to get rid of shadows in real life, just turn shadows off. And
what he needs is better lighting, but
the lighting's
he doesn't
want
to listen to us. No, because that's what creates the shadows.
That's the problem. He needs an actual backlight.
Yeah. God, Derek.
So you'd have like...
Don't tell me about lighting. I had lighting issues for like 5 months when I got my
I know, I love
screen.
When your window's not shut.
Yeah. Well, that I can't help. The sun, when the sun goes down, it's right outside my window.
Do you have blinds?
Yeah, but they're those shitty ones that like go down and then you like twist them and they like kind of like somewhat close, but they don't stop all
money?
The light coming in. What?
We should do a donation drive. Now you can your window.
Now you can trade in real blinds.
Now you can see more of my eVegas, the free eVegas. What the hell is this?
The
Blood Raiders t-shirt.
It's Blood Raiders, yeah. I got the same shirt on, but you'll never be able to see it.
It is funny that we tend to like wear the same t-shirts from time to time.
Yeah, well, fashion.
So moving on.
Moving on, what do we got going on? What's new in Eve this week? Apparently, CO2 remains under heavy pressure and isn't entirely active. Although Test is still doing some stuff. Apparently, PanFam lost a Rorqual the other night.
Excellent. I mean, sorry.
Killer was not happy at our response time. Got to be honest.
It's one Rorqual. I mean.
What was he doing, like mining somewhere
it's not
without
one
a sino?
Rorqual. That one Rorqual is the thing that now puts Test, like, you know, Test in the crosshairs.
Did it use its panic module?
Maybe it did. It did. It used its panic module. It was in a sino jammed system.
Oh, that's why you guys couldn't
see
it.
Apparently, from the stuff I was hearing over, over just general comms, there were a number of barriers to rapid response.
Well, yeah, I was gonna say, I was like, that's why you guys lost it. PL doesn't do well in systems without sinos.
Yeah, what are you gonna do when you can't drop supers on everything? Fucking lose is what.
That's right, man.
That's why PL does a mission in high set. You can't use supers.
That's why PL can't hold space properly. You know what I mean? Because they don't know about these things. Yeah. It's like whatever. Yeah. We ran down there and got there a little bit late and.
Well, I guess the big thing with that is Horde doesn't want tribute anymore, even though they're kicking CO2 out.
So they're kicking CO2 out to abandon the space.
Apparently. Yeah.
Freeport all the things.
Yeah. Well, shit.
That's just doing us a solid so we can get some of our stuff out, right?
Yeah, I don't know. It's kind of a shame that Horde doesn't want it. And then, you've already got people out there, wondering about the future of CO2. And it's like, look, honestly, if CO2 loses tribute, which which they're going to do, they've already, pretty much abandoned to a couple different areas at the moment. CO2 will still go on because the core of CO2 is this, tight behind GigX thing. There's, there's other, I don't want to call them hangers on, but there's others who haven't been with them for years, that might drift away because now they've lost, the sort of homeland and, just like when the Imperium lost their space, you had people going their separate ways because now they've lost their key ratting grounds and mining grounds and whatnot. And it'll take some time to kind of redevelop that. But, CO2 will continue to exist because they have an underlying culture that I think is fairly tight knit.
Yeah, I mean,
Reign of a True King needs your following. I thought I saw someone there.
I don't see anything.
The big question is the Keepstar, right?
Yeah.
The big question is whether or not the assets are put on the field to make that die.
Well, it didn't die. I remember last week they were getting ready to go for like the final kill push on it, and then obviously that never happened because it's still there.
Yeah, I just don't know that, like, you know, the assets that will ensure its death, you know, will be will be there, because, you know, what you have to trade in the process is pretty substantial, and that goes without, you know, whether or not there's a legitimate defense fleet or anything like that. Just, you know, just up against the Keepstar itself, you know, what are you willing to put on there for something that no longer usable by them.
But that's only if someone's actually defending it, because it's not like a pos. So you need at least someone in there with rules.
One guy sitting in the captain's chair,
yeah,
to use the weapon systems for that thing.
Yeah.
Which, you know, are fairly substantial weapons, you know, for you know what gets, you know, put on the field against it, you know, and either A, you're going to try and, you know, do it with, you know, a huge swarm of, you know, subcaps that, you know, max the deeps out, or, you know, you're going to have to drop some caps or something like that. And, you know, how many billions are you willing to give up for something that is not necessarily a strategic foothold for an enemy force? It's not like, you know, it's not like they're camped out in the Alamo and just, you know, waiting.
Yeah, but I mean, like, in this, like, yeah, in some cases maybe killing it would be like, eh, like, what strategic does it give us, like you were just saying, but this would be for like the first kill of one, so I'm pretty sure that just bragging rights that you'd want
to
get there.
It comes down
to
history books, right?
Yeah.
What do you want to put on the field to be the first one?
Because no one's going to remember who killed the third one. Everyone's going to remember who killed the first one.
That's true, right. But also, when you do the first one, you have to be the one to execute a strategy. So if you have what you think is a pretty solid strategy for killing a Keepstar, if you absolutely have to, why would you do that to kill a Keepstar, say, in space that you don't want to keep five ever, and then show all your opponents? Like, I mean, I think I saw Opa streaming just the Keepstar, just, like, waiting for its death. So obviously, like, it's not going to be, like, it's not going to die quietly. People are going to be watching.
Right, right. The nice thing about these citadels, well, I mean, maybe the smaller ones not as much, but definitely the Keepstars, is like you're pretty much not going to come away clean. You're going to lose a bunch of stuff killing this thing, and especially if someone's manning it, and it's just like you're going to have to probably be willing to lose several billions of ISK depending on how well the person is defending it, what they have it fit with. But I mean, you could lose several capitals, you could lose a couple supers, who knows. I don't know what these things can take down before they die, but and it's easy to say, like, oh, well, PL can afford that. They can. They got the ISK pool. They can afford it. But at the same time, just because you can afford it might not mean that that alliance wants to just toss that money down the garbage because they want to kill it.
It's like paying to be in the history books, you know what I mean?
Right. Well, I mean, I would do it, but I'm not in charge of a giant alliance like PL. Probably a good thing, too.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, you know, I would definitely like to see it die rather than trade hands. But I mean, I also do understand the economics of the situation, that, you know what, you don't throw money at you know what is ostensibly nothing. You know, it can be killed. It's just a matter of, you know, do I really want to bother? But I mean, the whole thing about this form of warfare, right, is even though somebody has a Keepstar that is incredibly unassailable, or not, I don't want to say unassailable, but it's very difficult to take it down, right? Once you deny them their space, once you deny them their use of the area, right, once you salt the earth, you know, around there, what is it? It's just this thing in space that
It might be pretty tough for them to take it down, though, because they take it down, they have to come pick it up, and good luck picking it up and not getting blown up while you're on your way out.
Oh, they're not going to do that, right? I mean, I guess the thing would be...
I mean, the option is available to pick it up, but...
It takes a week to
means there'll be a timer, and then PL will know exactly when it's coming down, and the only thing it'll fit in is a freighter, which means you're going to have a Titan there ready to bridge that freighter out somewhere. And that's not happening with PL on the watch. Like, it's not going to get out of the system. So it's either going to have to transfer or get killed.
Give a shout out to Eridanica. Haven't seen her
Eridanica's
in a while.
Here. I saw that too.
Haven't seen her in a while around the whole thing. Although I was watching Discord today, and I saw her pop up in Talking in Station's Discord. Matt are all saying hi to her. So I don't know. Maybe she's back for. Back for another go at EVE Online. Yeah, you're starting to see some people, you know, kind of, you know, come back, you know, see what's going on and see some of those things. But
yeah, I think I've seen her since Eve Radio.
And while we're on that, you know, things coming, people coming back, whatever. What was it? There was a dev blog about now. I believe it was released as of yesterday. I think that if you had. If you now create a new character on an existing account, an account that existed prior to Ascension, that you will be able to now run the new player experience. Before it was, you ended up with the old player, the old new player experience. Now you'll be able to run the new player experience. So if any of you were waiting for that out there, apparently, I believe it went into effect as of the little update yesterday.
New, you say?
New. Apparently, I need another fucking shot because I just can't even talk today. I am tired. And you know what? Thank God it's Friday. You know what? I'm doing a shot for thank God it's Friday.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I mean, it's just like, I don't know. This has been a fucking week from hell for me. And apparently for rain as well, but.
Yeah, it's pretty shitty.
But at least you got to go out to dinner with your family tonight.
I did. That was actually super exciting. So,
we're all going to do a shot. I don't know about Paul Sullivan. I don't see him raising
a glass.
We're
going
to drink. You know,
we're just not going to have a shot right now.
Okay.
Have a sip with us.
Thank God it's Friday shot.
A sip of your Molson Ice.
Molson Ice.
I feel like all the things that I'm kind of remembering right now are going to come out early. So, you know, I want to give a shout out. Well, I guess it's not really a shout out. It's more like a reminder. Since we are in the winter festive season, depending on, like, you know, what culture that you come from and, you know, what you want to call it and things like that. Mike Azariah has this thing called Operation Northern Troll. No, you don't have to, like, you know, send him money to, like, give free things to the little people or whatever. And Rain, correct me if I don't explain this correctly. It's basically send a Christmas card to CCP.
Yes, CCP's office in Iceland. I think he also links like their Georgia office or their London office as well. But it's mainly for the ones in Iceland. And just like write out a physical card, send them a picture, do like arts and crafts. Just send them something physical.
Like written, like, oh my God, like, we're not saying go to Hallmark and buy a $9.50 card or anything like that.
Yeah,
you know,
I've forgotten how to write.
If you want to send pizza or something, or, you know, if you want to, but whatever, yeah, you know, his thing is basically, you know, just send a little holiday wish, to the folks at CCP. I don't know. I mean, that's kind of, you know, I don't know. For
I
those
could probably only
it,
write about
nice.
5 words per minute, but I could type 40, something like that.
And you can, you know, send a picture of dick butt or, you know, with
yeah.
a Santa hat or something. That'll be the best. If you want to be real Eevee about it or something.
You should make dick butt skins, but put them on ships that transform like the Bastion modules. So like you
transform
don't see it
into dick butt?
Until it transforms and then dick butt just shows up. That'd be, oh, I'd actually pay money for that skin.
I'd pay for that one.
Yeah.
Yeah, remember when they? look at Rowanin sending that tweet out. All set to watch Open Comms show, and he's got that big handle of fucking Tito's sitting there. Oh my God, yeah. Dude! Shadow Broker tweeted at me. I think it was yesterday. That in 3 hours, as of whenever he sent the tweet or whatever, that he was gonna have some Tito's, and apparently he lives somewhere, you know, deep in the heart of Europe or whatever, because it was like making multiple jumps. To be able to get there, but it came out to something like $80 for the bottle. I'm number one.
Wow.
I hope it's like a 1.75. Okay, you know, I would hate to think it's just a fifth or something like that. But yeah, but it was like $80. I think it was like $80 US or something like that. Anyways, yeah, it was expensive. Like you know, apparently with the shipping, the way he was having it, sent. Which I'm gonna say this, okay. As much as I do honestly like Tito's, okay, number one, I am not a connoisseur of these things. I will not tell you that Grey Goose is bad. I will not tell you that Kettle One is bad. But for the price you pay for those, Tito's is a much better vodka. All right. That being said, I would not pay $50 to $80 a bottle.
For right, right. Because
number one, I wouldn't pay $50 to $80 a bottle for.
The reason Tito's is so good is because it's cheaper than like Grey Goose and some of those higher end ones, but it's almost just as good. But that's in America where we don't have to. Like, it's not imported, and right. A lot of other countries don't import that. So if you want it, you have to specially order it. Who was it? There was someone from England that was saying like, "Oh yeah, I can get that." And they're saying it's around
England,
like 40.
You can actually get it like through various.
Yeah, but someone was saying like, there, oh, I think it was Wiggles that was saying like, he's like, yeah, I can get it. It's about 35. I'm like, that's not too much more. It's about 24 here. And he's like, yeah, it's about 35 quid. I'm like, oh, 35 pounds. So that's like $50 for a bottle. Yeah. Okay, never mind. That's a bad price.
But since
don't
the
whole go,
Brexit
don't
thing,
get
35 quid doesn't mean what it used to mean. But
well,
but,
yeah,
know,
but
still,
it didn't drop
still,
that much.
You know,
it dropped like
more expensive.
It dropped like 20 cents to the dollar or something like that. But or 20 cents to the pound. It was like, what was a pound? It was like 160-ish. Now it's like 140-ish.
You didn't hear it. We did it like first thing off the bat.
Yeah. We gave you a shout out, Lysis. But happy birthday again.
Yeah, Lysis. We also did a shot for you.
But yeah, so I don't know. You guys tell me. Tell me. Rain, what have you been up to in Eve?
I've still been like solo PvPing, but that's kind of died down because of how busy and like shitty real life has been. But no, I've just been, I don't know. I
like,
still
real
live
life has been busy, or it's been shitty, or it's been shitty
both.
And busy?
Both, yeah. It's one of those things
so it's
of
been
like
a lot of shit.
Yeah, like, I
it's
mean, work has
means,
been busy.
It?
Yeah, like, work has been busy, like, regardless of the shitty stuff. But yeah, there's been a lot of shitty stuff.
Just in case you were going to ask me, but I'm going to say what I've been up to with Eve. I'm just grinding away missions.
You
weren't going to ask me?
No, I was going to skip over.
Well, fuck you there. All right, let's go to the next segment.
You're doing what?
I've just been grinding away on missions because I just went straight to the cruiser level 1 skill, and now I'm at level 2. I said fuck you to core skills, fitting skills.
Why aren't you following the Imperium down into Delve and making mad loot down there, man?
I'm down there, but
that is like the ISK making.
No, I'm down there, and I actually
did. Delve, man.
I'm down there, and I got in my ratting Ishtar and just went back to the good old days of sitting there and watching things die and money roll in without having to do a damn thing. But then this alpha stuff came out.
Apparently, the big moneymaker down there right now is mining because they
maybe
are mining the shit out of stuff. Down
that's
there.
If you have
like
a bunch of mining accounts. I don't.
An hour.
I mean, Drayden can fly a retriever. I'm not going to make big books. I'm not going to make big money just flying a retriever. But I don't know. I've been having fun with the alpha thing, and I was like, I want to
get you. You got to get your Rorqual game on, man.
Oh, that's actually like the
if
funny thing is like. Kessick is like my industry guy. Like he can fly jump freighters. He can fly two different races of jump. He can fly the Ark with max skills, and he's at level 4 with all the other jumping skills maxed out.
Arcs don't mine.
Did you guys?
I know. I'm just saying he can fly all his industry Bastion stuff, but he cannot fly a Rorqual or an Orca. He never got
like,
into the mining.
Did you know
side.
Some guys that were in the Bastion?
Yeah, so did I tell you about my run-in with Bastion the other day? I, like, stumbled across them. I was, like...
You had a run-in with them? Like.
Yeah, so I was streaming, and I was just, like, wormhole diving, like, exploration. And I stumbled into, like, Bastion's headquarters. Like, you click on their alliance, their, like, capital or whatever. That's where I was.
I can't, like, the funny thing is I'm stationed there. It's, like, I can't even think of it now. It's, like, something-6. That's the system? D-6? It's something tech 6.
I don't remember. But
it's wherever my guy is. But
when you say you ran into them, do you mean like you went through a gate and you went, oh shit?
No, like I popped through a wormhole and they're like, oh shit. Like someone types in local, they're like, neutral local. And I'm like, no, it is just me. But I was on
sound
my
air
call.
But you are neutral.
So, you know, like,
what do you mean, no, it's just me?
So I linked my stream, and I'm like, no, it's just me. I'm exploring. And so,
you,
like...
Well, that's neutral. You don't... Are you blue to Bastion?
No, not at
then
all.
You're
so
neutral. Then you're a neutral and local.
I was a neutral. So I'm just talking to them, and I managed to get the wormhole back through, and I was, like, just looking for sites. And Bastion, like, they had came into my stream, and they're like, oh, you should come back. I'm like, okay. Well, I dropped all my stuff off, so the wormholes probably can't, but I'll just go say hi. So I warp in, and
we're not smart enough to camp wormholes.
Yeah, they didn't camp the wormhole, and then I warped to the ESS, and it, like, the ESS is where it announces in local, and it acts as, like, a bubble, but you can make ISK from it or whatever.
I hate those things.
So, like, I panicked and warped away, and then I found they had a Roracle, and I found it in an ice spell, and it had, like, a bunch of other, like, little mining ships, and it was in, like, industrial mode, and I'd never seen that. So, like, to me, I was like, oh, that's
you,
so cool.
You warped in your cheetah, and, like, it immediately went into a panic mode?
No.
Because it was the Draenei Roracle that went, oh, my God, a cheetah.
No. That was, I was PvPing, and I freaked out over an anathema. And Athma came by, I was like, oh shit, run away, fuck the loot.
Yeah, so I had warped in and like I was just cloaked talking to them and just like looking at it because I thought the, like, I think the Roracle effects are actually pretty cool. And
it
then,
does look cool.
Yeah, but like they didn't like chase me around, they like didn't shit talk me or like were rude or anything. They just kind of chatted with me and then I flew off and like, that was so sweet.
When you said you warped to the ESS, I was like, you should have just fucking looted that thing.
Well, it was sitting on a citadel, and so I was just like, oh my god,
yeah,
this is
such bad
news.
Yep, then that was we have it sitting right above our citadel. You still should have looted it, because no one would have done anything.
I would have felt bad, stealing.
That's the one thing I hate about the space down there that I rat in. I fucking hate ESSs. I know you can make more money with them, the 5% increase, but I...
Don't fight the system, Drew.
I
just go
hate
with it.
Those things so much.
No.
Because it's like, when I don't want a bunch of my money getting pooled into that thing that I hope I get it back later. And it's like...
It gets hoovered in.
It's like, it takes time to go cash it out. You have to sit there. And people get pissed when you cash it out because they're like, I'm not done yet. You're going to reset it. It's like, well, fuck you. I'm done ratting, and I don't want my money sitting in here for someone to come steal it.
He who owns the ESS, you know, is the one that's usually in control.
Oh, no. When I'm done ratting, I go empty that thing, and I de-gaff. I'm like, I don't give a fuck who's still ratting. I'm done ratting, and I want my money now. I'm emptying this. Fuck all you. Fuck all you in system. Fuck you. I'm getting my money. You don't want me to do that? Take this shit down.
That's not working as a community, Drayden. That's not
maybe the
working
problem's not
them.
Yeah, fuck ESS. Yeah, and the thing I was like, well, all right, fuck this system. I'll go to literally every single system you go to within like 10 jumps of that system, all of them have an ESS in them.
When the ESS first came out, okay, it sucked, okay? And I'm only going to say this, I'm only going to say that it sucked because the day before, right, you were getting 100% of your take, right? And then they trimmed the amount of take that you would be able to get without an ESS, so you felt like there was a bit of a nerf if you weren't using one. I think a lot of people out there adapted to not using one, and by now it's kind of...
It wasn't a nerf. It did
a
not
lot of the
it.
People
was just,
that are out there
you made the
out
same
may not even know of a time before what the kind of ratting income was prior to that change, and some of them are using an ESS. Maybe a lot of them are using an ESS.
Yeah. Whoa. Hold on. Now this was the other thing with the, like, it's not a nerf not using the ESS because it's, you get the same amount of money. It's just a buff if you use it because you have the potential to get more money.
Right.
But, and you also get LP. So if you get an Amar one, you get Amar LP, vice versa, and all that stuff. But Ronan's saying the ESS would be better if the LP didn't go away after a while. I didn't know that. Does the LP just disappear after if you don't use it?
I've never heard of that happening.
I didn't either. So. But if that's a thing, that's even more fucked up.
I've never heard that.
Yeah, your LP is yours. Like, it's a loyalty.
Oh, yeah. And Ari Danik is saying, what's an ESS? It's an electronic surveillance something system. I don't know. It's a
structure system.
It's something you put up in the system.
It's a new structure. It's just a small thing that you put out in space. And basically by putting that out in space, that's right. Encounter surveillance system. Yeah. You deploy it into space like you would deploy a can, like you would deploy a bubble. It's just a small deployable. But what it does is it basically, you know, ups the. The more activity in system, the more kind of a bonus percentage you get to ratting.
Right.
And you get it by way of both kind of ISK that gets banked into the ESS.
I think 20%.
As well as LP. And, you know, however, it is susceptible to somebody coming by and stealing from it, meaning that, you know, if an enemy comes by, they can warp up to this thing and like, you know, it takes a minute to kind of, you know, cash it out.
And they're automatically pointed by the thing and they're in a bubble.
They're automatically pointed. They can't just warp off.
And they're scrammed. So even scepters can't warp out of the bubble.
So, you know, so what it's there to do is it's there to give you A bit of a boost to your ratting income, but that boost is banked in the module itself, so to speak. So that if an enemy comes by, you have to choose whether or not to, you know, kind of defend it or let them steal it or whatever.
Or
if
share
you
it.
Shut it off, it then resets itself back to kind of the early stage. So it's kind of a give and take sort of thing on trying to create something worth fighting.
It's like
over.
An investment. It banks 20% of your rattiness, so you get only 80% of the ISK from ratting. The other 20% gets banked in this thing, but then over time it can build up to another 5% of that. And then if you share it, and you can either steal it, which is what enemies will do, or you can share it. And if you share it, then everyone gets the payout plus the bonus. So you can get, and you get LP as well from killing rats. So it using it is a way to get more money than you normally would from ratting. And if you're doing large ratting long, like if you're going to rat for like 5 hours and do a bunch of big ratting exercises, you can actually make quite a bit of substantial extra ISK doing that. I just hate them. I hate them because it's a fucking hassle, and I don't like having potential amounts of my money sitting there. Because I don't like docking up and be like, well, I'm going to log off, and I hope that someone cashes it out before someone comes by and steals it. Because I know if someone came by to steal it, no one in that system would go out to try to kill him. That's what I'm saying, Rain. You should have stole it and taught him a lesson.
Oh, next time you go, nice
I'm telling you, I am in the Bastion, and I'm telling you right now, if you come into Bastion space, please, please, please steal everything from every ESS you find. Please do it.
Again, depending on where it's deployed.
Once somebody comes into it, then somebody gets in the Citadel and they gun it and they shoot whoever's trying to.
Well, that requires people actually.
I mean, when they first came out, they were sticking these things in spawned anomalies. You know, so that if you warped in on it, you know, because again, if you try to engage the thing to steal from it, you're to either steal from it or to, you know, to share it with people out there, you're pointed. So there's no, you know, there's no warping off from it. You can burn out of its range, but once you've burned out of its, you know, narrow range, then it kind of shuts off either stealing or sharing or whatever. You know, and in the middle of a, you know, in the middle of an anomaly, it creates kind of a death trap situation.
I'm sure I'll hear from Pukin later. He's like, what the fuck, bro? Don't tell people to steal our shit. It's like, hey, man.
The ESS still generates that, like, NPC rat field around it, doesn't it?
What? I don't think so.
What?
No.
Or am I thinking of something else?
You must be thinking of something else. No, it just has a bubble around it.
I thought there used to be rats.
You're thinking of when people would put it in an anomaly and fully spawn it to keep people from flying in and stealing shit.
Right, and that's why you'd go in your pod. Now I remember.
Yeah.
But you're right, Drayden. I mean, it is tough if you're in what I'll call a highly active shared system. You know, do you want your, do you want your stuff when you're done, even though you know that it's going to reset it for everybody else who might still be ratting, maybe some guy just started ratting and something like that. I mean, it is harder, and that is one of the difficulties of those kinds of systems.
Well, and that's the thing. It's like
if somebody does come and try to steal from it, you would hope that in a system that's busy like that, that somebody would get out there and try to defend the thing.
Well, and here's the thing, like, because if you're doing a big, large ratting operation, they're really good. But I'm not one of those people that's like, I'm gonna log in and rat for 6 hours. I don't do that shit. I go in, I log in, I rat for like an hour or two on one guy. I just like rat on Drain. It's like I'll go and make a 150, couple hundred million ratting, and then I'm done. And I only do that like a couple times a week, so it's like, I mean, I'm not.
You gotta
those,
want it, Drayden.
I don't rat every it. Day. I don't. It's like I don't make billions of ISK a month ratting.
You don't sound
it's
like
I make enough ISK to go buy some shit that
I'm
might.
Insane. He's gotta want it.
But here's the thing. So when I like for the people that are doing those big, large scale things, if you empty it early, that could fuck them over like several hundreds of millions of ISK. Whereas for me, it might only fuck me over if I leave it and it gets stolen. I might only get screwed over like, you know, maybe 60 million. But that 60 million is like 20% of the shit I just spent 2 hours doing. And it's like, I hate those things. So I don't know. I just wish they were never put up in the first place. But
well, think about it this way. When you log into RAT, there's a pretty good chance that it's already up to the plus 5% ISK. Because nobody's accessed it.
That's
right?
Actually really nice.
Assuming some guy like Drayden hasn't come by and said, "I want my shit."
Do enjoy when people have built it up and haven't cashed it out. Because then it's like, sweet, I'm gonna start it up and I'm already starting at 5%, and I rat for like an hour, and then I go empty the thing and get my extra like 10. I get like 5 or 10 million ISK bonus, and I just screw everyone over like 100 million ISK. But yeah, I'm an asshole.
I just saw Eric Danica's tweet out there. Listening to Dirk McGregor and Friends on the Open Comm show, even line has changed so much. What's a keep star? See, I'm telling
yeah,
you right now.
Yeah, she doesn't even know what to say to those.
Well, that's just it, right? I mean, if you were somebody who, say, left the game, God, okay, let's say 2 years ago. 2 years ago, you've come back to an entirely different world. You've come back to a completely different sovereignty system. You've come back to, you know, massive changes in capital jumping and, you know, everything, right? You know, all the way up to now, the Ascension, you know, expansion and the introduction of, you know, free to participate. There's actually quite a bit of change. Now, if you've been here all along, right, each one of these things has been kind of incremental and it's like, you know, climbed its own little mountain, you know, and may seem like, you know, little pieces to an overall giant puzzle. But if, yeah, I mean, 12 months ago, 18 months ago, certainly 24 months ago, it is like an entirely different world. It looks the same. It just feels incredibly different.
Except for the explosions.
Except for the explosions, except for things like skins. But, you know, honestly, if you're just coming back, you know, chances are, you know, you're not seeing skins anyways. But
yeah, she's asking all the questions. She's like, what's an alpha clone? But I already answered the alpha clone, so we got that. In a simple way, but
it is. I mean, you know, it's amazing, and you know, and I mean, again, if you've been around kind of through these changes, it may like there's a lot of people out there that think, you know, the game hasn't changed all that much, but I'm telling you right now, if you come back, you know, after being away a year, or, you know, hell, at this point, even 6 months, you know, there's a lot that has changed, you know, fundamentally with the game. Certainly with the placement of, you know, of people out there. I mean, you know, a year ago the Imperium was a big giant dog, and you know now it's another one of the big dogs, but it's certainly not you know the biggest dog out there.
Who is the biggest dog out there?
Yeah, Dirk.
Who is the biggest Dirk. Dog out there? Well, I,
yeah, Dirk.
Yeah, Dirk.
They are by size still the biggest dog, right? Now whether or not they are the dog with the biggest bite is a different story.
So it's like an obese dog.
No, I'm not saying it's an obese dog. It's just, you know, it doesn't, you know, necessarily have the same the same jaw grip that maybe it once did. That being said, there's more parity, I think, at the top, unless what you see is it would require the formation of another major coalition to, I think, you know, begin to move on something like, you know, Fortress Delve at this point. Maybe not the same coalition as it required before, but it would require something akin to that. So as an individual entity, I think that they probably still are the biggest dog out there. As far as, you know, a war that might occur that was related to them, you know, I would think that there's more parity now than there was in the past.
Yeah, I don't think anybody really cares about the Imperium right now.
Too many silent shots. Silent shot.
I was answering.
Yeah, whenever there's like a gap in between, that was the gap that BC would have said something in, by the way.
Well, I know. I was. Marsha came in. She's like, what's up, piss artist? And I was just like, wait, what? Oh, yeah, UK. Yeah, piss is. It's such a different term in the UK than it is here. I was like, sometimes if it's, you know, if there's snow on the ground, I'll do some art, but
shots. But as I was saying before, from a mining perspective, I don't think there's anybody that's out there. There is no region out mining Delve right now. They are mining some bitches down there. I mean, yeah, there was somebody saying
Keepstar is the biggest dog at the moment, apparently.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, this guy
fucking ghost town.
Nana Galinsky keeps saying he's like, PL is scared off by a structure greater than PL. He's just like,
those structures are bitches, man. I mean that one there, or not that one there, but Keepstars in general. Daughter telling me she's going out fucking 9:41 at night.
You're not gonna fucking like get the binoculars and like the like.
Tell her she better be home by 11.
What binoculars am I gonna?
You'd like spy on her to make sure she's okay.
No,
Dirk.
That's creepy. You get called in the cops.
Your daughter. If you do that to random,
she's going
women,
out.
Then
it's
creepy.
You mean like I'm gonna like get
to follow
and
her?
Go drive and
yeah.
There's a whole freaking story about a few weeks ago, but whatever.
Did you actually do that?
No, I would never. No, no.
Oh man, I won't say it. There's a story I have about.
Apparently, she puked in a closet a couple weeks ago.
My dad with my, what? My sister.
Apparently, okay. My rule of never accept an open drink. Okay. You know, unless it's, you know, well, never accept an open drink. Period.
Your daughter was underage drinking.
I'm not saying.
How
that.
Dare she? No one's ever done that.
Yeah, that's never happened in the history of children.
And you know, she was given something called jungle juice and was told there was no alcohol in it.
Oh my god.
Okay. So, you know, so she drank it.
She was at a fraternity party, wasn't she?
No, she was not at a
frat party. Wait, she's going to a frat party at 15?
No,
hell
no,
no.
No, she was not at a fraternity
Dirk
party.
Dirk could go to the machine gun. He'd go Scarface on those motherfuckers.
Okay, but no, she was not at a fraternity party, but I'm like, number one, okay, anything called jungle juice, I'm telling you, there's alcohol in. Number two, or she ended up puking in somebody's closet.
Oh no!
In the closet.
Hide it.
And was the it house on the coats?
And the house was for sale.
Somebody shit on the
coats. I'm like good. That's what that motherfucker gets for serving something where people were telling my daughter there was no alcohol in it.
Yeah.
And then I like proverbially smacked her for number one. You never drink anything from an open container that somebody hands you. I don't give a shit who fucking hands it to you. You get your own goddamn drinks, or you drink. Well, number one, and this is the father I am, right? I recognize that my child, okay, I recognize that kids out there, whether they be in high school or underage in college, are going to drink, right? So I've always had the thing of listen to me. I don't want you to lie to me. If you ever need me to come get you, I will ask no questions. Okay, yep. Because my primary concern is your safety, not whether or not you're doing something that I know if I force you to hide that you're still going to do, because I did it. We all did it.
Yeah.
So whatever.
Well, that's the thing. Like, it's always the parent. They're like,
puked some shit up in some dude's fucking closet, or like in somebody's house, where apparently it's on the market to be sold. So it's like, I'm like, hey, whatever.
Yeah. The nice thing, like, how often do they use that closet? If there's someone that never uses their closet, like me, it would take some time. Well, I'm sure the smell would. It would take some time to be able to find, like, what the fuck is that? What the fuck is that in my closet? My closet is storage.
Like,
I don't.
You never really used. You know
I
mean?
Don't use my closet. My closet is storage. I don't hang shit up.
Bill the Boss says we used to make this.
I'm in Idaho. We don't care about like having
naked juice, which is pretty much. And then it's like, I'm sitting there and it's like, I'm pissed off about the fact that, she didn't follow the logical fucking rules that I set out, which were, don't drink from an open container that you don't know what's in it. Okay. And don't ever believe somebody when they tell you, don't worry, there's nothing in this. All right. And then her mother's like across the room going, jungle juice. That's just freaking grain punch. She's like, of course you can't taste it. They mask it with flavor.
I'm pretty sure
God.
If someone said, like, here, have this, don't like worry, there's nothing in this, that's even more of a reason
that's
to be worried,
now,
because
right?
That means there's definitely fucking something
that,
in that.
If they open with that, like, here, have
if
this.
If they open with, here, it, have this, don't worry, there's nothing in it, dump that shit out right now, because that is full of fucking roofies.
Hey,
it's like jungle juice. Anything called jungle juice, you have to imagine, is probably not like
I'm pretty sure
a first
jungle
world
juice
beverage of choice.
No, so jungle juice, I think, is specifically something done at frat parties where they just kind of start with this massive, I don't want to say jug or barrel, but it's a pretty massive container, and then people just bring things and dump it in. So it's not like a mixed drink of like punch and alcohol or lemonade and alcohol or like soda and alcohol. It's pretty much just like, oh, you brought some mixer, dump it in. Oh, you brought fucking a bottle of Tito's, dump it in. And that's
so
what they do.
So it's just like the mutt drink.
And
Lieutenant Dan is subscribing for 15 months in a row.
Yeah, he says, shots for parenting tips with Dirk.
Seriously, you know what? Dirk is actually a cool fucking dad. I mean, despite, whatever. I'm cool from the standpoint that, I recognize what it was I did as a youth, and I'm not going to try and pretend that I can stop somebody else from doing the same thing that I did and my father probably did, and I don't know, maybe even his father probably fucking did, whatever. It's like, I'm much more focused on the safety and well-being than I am on whether or not my child is doing something that I would prefer that she didn't do. But, and it pretty much always comes down to, I don't care what you do. It only comes down to your safety and health. So as far as I'm concerned, if I have to go pick her up at a goddamn party because she got drunk and the person who was supposed to drive that night decided that they were going to drink as well, I have no problem. I'm not going to fucking report anybody. I'm just there to pick up my daughter and bring her home.
Has she done that before? Because I always
no, no. And you know what's funny is, number one, she didn't have a fucking boyfriend until she was a junior in high school. She, as far as I know, did not drink until this year. I won't say that she hadn't that probably sampled something year. Because I know it was last year when I made her try like a little tiny sip of Tito's and she damn near gagged on it.
You made her like you will drink this.
Well, I did. I mean, you know, it was it was on Twitch. It was stupid. It was a fucking dumb thing.
Wait,
to
you
do.
Did it like, on Twitch?
It was on Twitch. It was fucking late at night.
You're the parent though. You're in the parent in your own
right.
Household
but see that
account.
The funny
okay.
thing is like but, that's actually not illegal because if it's in
it's
your house if it's in your house on your private property and the parental consent
no
is there,
no,
it's not illegal
to
give your children
it has nothing
alcohol.
To do, it has nothing to do with what's legal. It only has to do with what fucking, Twitch Yule is and all that kind of shit, I'm concerned. But,
True,
I mean, she's not somebody who enjoys the taste of this stuff or anything like that. And
well, it's not like here, like,
I
take
this
whole glass
and
give her a sip
openness,
of it.
Due to my own openness with her, she is open in return and we converse about it. It's not to say that she's not going to make the same dumb mistakes that other people her age and older do, but I think it's a matter of again, get rid of in a way it's almost like legalizing pot and stuff like that. Why are we focused on shit that really doesn't fucking matter when we need to focus on more serious things? And as far as I'm concerned with my only child, I only have one shot at getting it right, and I will do everything I can to protect, that getting done right.
Hey,
that's so cute.
If I had
of
like
Dirk
three
being
kids,
a parent.
I knew that I had like backups.
Yeah.
Just a regular parent or a good parent?
The first two can like fuck up. Besides the fact, she's got some hot friends that are always coming around, so that's like whatever.
Oh, easy.
Holy shit, Dirk! How old are these
what
friends?
What the fuck? Jesus Christ, Drayden, that's even worse.
I'm not saying they're hot. They're friends of
you just said
they're hot.
What? You just said she's got hot
I'm
friends coming over. You don't. I don't know that they're hot. They've been over to your house.
I'm
calling you on
this.
Them.
I've like, never seen them apparently in their hot.
And Ray, that's why I asked. That's why I asked the age first.
My boyfriend, and now they're hitting on underage girls.
No.
I don't get it.
I wasn't hitting on your boyfriend that much.
Dirk was.
I thought about it.
That was in the conversation like a couple weeks ago.
No, that's what I was asking. Because if he's like,
do you remember at Vegas? You were like hitting on me. Your wife was hitting on my boyfriend.
I was just out to fucking bang, man. It was Vegas. You know what I mean? It's like, whatever. I was down, Rain. You know what I mean? I was trying to get you up to senior co-host status, but whatever.
What?
There's an initiation, right? I've been through it.
Yeah, I banged Rain last year.
You gotta work to get to this spot.
Okay, so what's coming up this weekend? Darn Canadian?
Oh, yeah. Your tournament, DC.
What about it?
Yeah, I hear you're doing some small, 1v1 frigate thing.
Yeah, that's happening tomorrow.
Now, is it only people in TNT? So, like, we know that there's only going to be, like, six people in the tournament? Or
there's, well, come on now.
It's just me and Paul.
It's not like anybody's going to lose one fight there and then, go to PL or something.
The two contestants are both commentators?
No, I'm not competing. I'm just organizing it and streaming it. But LB is competing and co-streaming it with me.
Yeah, and something you can look forward to, hit us up with that soundboard there, DC.
Oh, right. Yeah, that. Hold on.
All right. I mean, coming to you live.
I just want
to
throw this out there real quick.
Yeah.
And since you played that song, I just want to say, Cowboys, not Vikings. Sorry, Roanne. But Big Bill the Boss, I just want to flash back here to what I was saying about mining before. Big Bill the Boss 3 says, hey guys, regarding EVE Online, you know those mining stats didn't include Exhumer drones.
Wait, what?
He's saying that that the mining stats didn't include Exhumer drones. Yeah. Now, I don't know if that's true about the results that Quant put out today, but maybe... It might be because you know they were talking about like millions of, I think it was ISK, ISK value mined or whatever, but if it wasn't wow, then they are really mining the fuck out of shit down there. And
dude, there's like fleets of 20-30 robots going around just like nomming
Nostrovia.
Alpha, what's up, Nostrovia?
2.1 trillion ISK last month.
I have to do a shot now that I said Nostrovia because it's like automatic.
See, who needs casinos when you have Rorquals?
Oh, CCP what
Alpha.
Was
you
the...
You need to change your name to CCP Trump.
Hold on.
Just for that supreme Russian Trump connection. Ugh, my country. Anybody watching that show Incorporated? It was pretty funny. It was pretty funny because I watched the first episode last night. I watched the pilot last night. No, we're not doing TV already, but it was funny when they sat there and they said that 12 million Americans had illegally moved to Canada and they were building a wall. But whatever. Right, no, we're not doing TV
out.
Time.
Now, hold on. Before...
Nostrovia shot.
Yeah. Oh, fuck. I'm not pre-pulled.
I'll pass on this one since I did not say Nostrovia.
I'm not doing another fucking silence shot here, so like.
No, I was taking a shot. Now, real quick, this might be way the fuck out in left field right now for what we're talking about, but it was something that LB linked before, which is kind of, and someone in Twitch was mentioning the mining, the Exhumer drones. So this link right here, I just posted it in chat, is basically showing a graph of the level 4 missions that.
Yeah, this is pretty interesting.
The acceleration, the activation.
It shows
so it's like
how changes in the game can happen. Yeah.
Right. So there's
He linked it. So let LB punch in here. LB. LB's not one who fights for talk time. So we're gonna throw it to LB to tell us what this graph means.
Enlighten us on what this graph means.
So basically, there's a piece of loot, the drone, enhanced drone AI or something like that. I'm not sure on the exact term, that drops in this level 4 mission called Silence the Informant. So if you look at this graph, you could see the huge jump right after EVE Ascension of people going out and farming this level 4 mission compared to the other level 4 missions. It's pretty significant. The other question I have is always, does this loot not drop in drone lands? If this is a piece of drone AI or a piece of drone loot, does it drop in the drone lands, and how much are they picking up if it's even dropping out there?
Well, and the drone loot is for, it's building these Exhumer drones, right?
Yeah, you need it to build the Exhumer drones.
Yeah, so that's what I found.
See,
it almost sucks that
that comes up in a mission, okay? And maybe it comes up at a reduced rate. One would think that it would come up in the drone lands at a much more substantial rate, right? Maybe one of those things that makes you want to own space in the drone lands, kind of a change.
I used to live out in the drone lands, and it was shit. Right before I moved out, they
changed. It was shit when? When did you live
I lived in the drone lands when it was
drone
fucking...
alloys time? Or like,
I
or like
lived at the end of the alloys that. Time, and that was the best time of my life.
I was after that.
Yeah.
After that, wasn't...
Definitely post great. Alloys, the drone regions for like, a number of years were literally fucking shit compared to other parts of space. But pre that, I'm just going to say it now. I miss gun mining from the standpoint of it was a differentiator in this game.
We got Avalon.
I think it's what it was actually put in for, was to be a differentiator. And then it was turned into a lesser pony that eventually, like with some of the changes they made with drones, was brought back kind of semi on par. CCP Avalon!
Yeah.
I'm not doing a shot.
Yeah, like,
he just showed up.
See...
and I have no Icelandic saying to Nostrovia.
The drone alloys were just way too good, but man, that was such a good time to live in the drone lands, and I only got about 3 weeks.
No,
of
no,
it.
Bullshit. They weren't way too good, okay? You weren't making more money, I don't think. I don't think that you
maybe
were making
not.
More money, okay? Doing.
All I know is that when they took them away, you made way less money. Like, well, drone lands were the worst region to live in after
making
that.
Making more money running 00 anomalies out in the drone regions under drone alloys, okay, than you were doing, you know, missions, you know, I'm sorry, not missions, you know, anomalies in, say, Garisa Space or wherever.
Right? I think it depended on what you were
because
doing.
Because you had to pick the shit up, okay? It mattered that you looted the wrecks. And
right, right, right,
like
but
that,
here's
right?
the thing.
That's how you got paid. You got paid by looting it and then bringing it to market. And that is one of the things that I think is absolutely cool, as opposed to the shoot 'em, get paid, fucking, you know, Garista.
Well,
you know,
right.
Theory.
Well, but here's the thing, like, yeah, because the drones back when alloys were around, the drones had zero bounty. Like, you got no money for killing the drones. You only got money for selling the loot.
No bounty.
You only got money by selling the alloys that they dropped. So you had to loot them, otherwise you were ratting for no money at all. But
so similar to sleeper drones in a wormhole.
I've actually never done wormhole stuff, so
in the wormhole, the sleeper drones have no bounty. It's all in the
Yeah. Basically, the same thing.
It's
yeah.
all in what you pull out
but,
of the wreck.
Exactly. But here's the thing: now, if you were just doing like a local, your own like little solo ratting thing, like you'd go rat a site, maybe come later with even a Noctis. Like, I mean, when I was doing it, I was still early enough that I was just doing it in a Drake and coming and picking it up in a fucking Badger with one tractor beam on it. I don't know what that is, Dirk. What is that?
It's a level. And I'm now going to use this as a way, like when I need to leave the show, because if I can no longer keep the level, then that's when I have to go.
We're only an hour in.
That's... Don't try too hard.
I just saw it on the floor. I just came up with this now. This wasn't something I thought about earlier
How about this?
Today.
Put it on top of your monitor.
I'm like, what can I do with this level?
Hold on, Dirk. Put it on top of your monitor. When the level goes off kilter, then you can leave the show.
Well, my monitor is always level, like relatively.
Exactly.
Level.
Anyway, but no, I'm just saying, like, but like, so if you're doing your own thing, like you go out, you rat, you kill a bunch of stuff, you come back, you pick up all this stuff, it makes you some decent cash.
It's high
scratch?
To the left, apparently.
It makes you some scratch. You get that Skrilla coming in the bank roll. But anyway, but there
Gangster
was people
telling it like it is.
Yeah, yeah. For show.
I love the idea. Okay, I love the idea that there is a place out there that is different from all of the others. That I love the idea that, you know what, it's not just shoot, get cheese, right?
Right.
You actually have to do something related
cheddar?
To it. Cheddar. And it was never, you know, it was, yeah, sorry, shoot, get cheddar, okay? All right.
Cheddar.
It was never about being so much more profitable than every place else. And they got away from that, I think, based on the premise that you could shoot something and get minerals, as opposed to, it was a differentiating factor to the, you know, to kind of the rest of the game as to a different place. And one of the things that did not exist out there, because it was heavily dominated by yes, the Russian rental field, of people that were out there, PvP organizations did not want to live out there. Okay, like straight up PvP organization, because their people could not go out there and just, like, you know, shoot, get cheddar.
Well, and here's the thing.
They had to actually do some extra work associated with it.
But, yeah, but, like, now, like I was saying, like, on, like, a general average player level, it probably wasn't that much more or less profitable than what most other people were getting around the game. But on the people that would go out, I mean, I don't know, remember the names, but the people in PNG and some, and that were going out, there was this one guy, he would go out and he would do, like, carrier ratting in these drone things, and he would come by, like, he would run his multiple carriers in, like, multiple sites at a single time in systems, and he was pulling in, like, the amount of money he would make off the drone alloys once all said and was done, like, when he got them all sold and everything, he was pulling in, like, I think he said, like, around 200 million ISK ticks. Now, that was probably with about 8 characters, so, you know, divide that down,
yeah, exactly.
It's probably not
you,
a ton, but...
when you get down into the per-character thing, look...
But I mean,
the
like
time,
it's like that's
the time
so
of the
much
drone
more
alloy
money.
Region was before, you know, it was before the mobile tractor unit. It was before the Noctis, okay?
The Noctis was around when I came in.
That was for you, okay? But
towards the end it was there, but yeah.
All right, the time of it, okay, you know, was before all those things, all right? Now, once they put in things like the mobile tractor unit,
The Noctis came around way before that, okay?
And then they put in the mobile tractor unit. That completely changed the game in a way that I think is still probably pretty freaking bad today, considering some of the other changes that they've made to the game. But again, a differentiating factor. There used to be a difference in owning space around kind of Eve that doesn't quite exist today the way that it, the way that it did back then.
I wonder, okay, so I didn't know, because when I started playing, the Noctis was already in the game. So I don't know when the Noctis came in, but I wonder if maybe that's why they decided the drone alloys were too overpowered, was once the Noctis came into play, they're like, okay, now these drone alloys are too good. Because back before, you had to spend a lot of time picking that stuff up, and now that the Noctis is here, it's just like warp in, 2 minutes later, grab money, cash out.
We found other ways to do it. We used to use Rorquals. Somebody would run a Rorqual to be the loot scooper. Okay,
slower than a Noctis was, because Noctis you get like four tractor beams
with extended range.
Well, if you didn't care about salvage, you just ran 8 tractor beams and just pulled all that shit in like fucking candy. But on top of that, though, like not only was it good for making a bunch of money, but also the drone regions during the alloy time was probably the best place to do production because you didn't have to go mine. You just ratted. You could like do full on production without having mining alts. You could just like rat, get a shitload of alloys, and just get all your production done with those alloys.
It goes back to the whole compression of minerals thing. Okay, and again, I shouldn't just say that it was before the Noctis. It was before the mobile tractor unit. It was also before the whole idea of ore compression and getting rid of the compression that was built into modules and reprocessing. So there were a number of changes that corresponded that alloys were outside of that realm. Alloys contained a lot of material that was in a compressed form. And that was one of the things that a couple of years ago that they were trying to get rid of because they wanted to get rid of this idea of building 425 millimeter, rail guns to be able to ship out and then melt them down into their components. But yeah, I mean there were a number of things that went into this, but again, I go back to the idea of differentiating space, and I think that is something that they need to think about. What is the reason for holding this particular space versus that particular space over there? And I think that's been broken to some extent. They've gotten rid of things like bottlenecks. They've gotten rid of a number of these things that were really the reason why a powerful group would decide to own the best space in the game if that existed. It doesn't quite exist anymore the way that it used to.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I was just saying, like, the money was great with the alloys. Just because
it wasn't so much that the money was great, dude. Okay, the money was not necessarily comparable because here's the thing, right? There's no legitimate full on. AFK Ishtar ratting in the drone.
There wasn't. You had to actively shoot them. But here's the thing. Most of the battleships...
No, it's not that you had to actively shoot them. But because you had to pick them up, okay? Because you had to haul them
but
back.
But even the time spent picking them up was well worth it. Because here's the thing. An average battleship rat nowadays, what do you... some are about 1.2, some are about 800,000. So and I would say, give or take an average, about 1 million ISK per battleship rat, right? In bounties? Close?
Yeah,
back then,
higher on average.
A battleship rat would sometimes it'd drop about 1 million ISK worth of alloys. Sometimes you get about 2 to 3 million ISK worth of bounties per battleship rat.
If you're going to pick that stuff up,
if you want to save on time and space, you only picked up like the plushie and the like 3 alloys that were like the best ones to pick up. And if you just went and only picked up those, and you just skirted the sites and just did that really quick. You made, because I was saying, like, I averaged it out. I was making about 18 million ISK per tick, ratting those the alloys. When I was I was flying a Drake with meta fits, like meta tank, meta missile launchers. I was not doing much damage. And then a year later, when I was flying Tech 2 fit ships in the most ISK efficient ratting way possible, I was making like 14, 15 million ISK per tick. So I was making less money a year later than I was a month into the game.
Marshmallow says you also create shortages if you buff one area with stuff needed elsewhere, and bottlenecks are a bitch for industrialists. Let me say this, okay? And it goes along the lines of what HiSec is for, what NullSec is for, the whole idea of a trade network kind of a thing. The fact of the matter is that when you have differing things in differing places, that creates trade. Okay, and it creates trade that finds itself to a central location that then disperses that material outwards once again. So, you know, if you have Mexilon coming from here, and you have Megasite coming from there, and you have Tritanium coming from here, it all seems to find itself to a central or several kind of, you know, centralized locations that then disperses it out to the broader universe. And that creates trade, it creates transit, it creates movement, it creates things that can be interdicted and things that can be killed. Now, there are some people who believe that each of these areas should be kind of somewhat self-sufficient, let's say. I think that that's absolutely wrong. I think it's absolutely against what we believe in kind of a real-world context of kind of a globalized economy.
Encouraging
and
trade
and
between
like
regions
that
is better for everything, I think.
Yeah, I mean, you know, low ends tended, back in the day, okay, you know, low ends tended to come from HiSec areas. High ends tended to come from NullSec areas. Now, not every NullSec area was created equally. There were some NullSec areas that had, you know, much more of this and less of that.
Yeah, I was saying the mid ends were like dispersed. Like one region might be better for Mexilon, whereas another one might be better for like Isogen and, you know, stuff like that. It's like the mid ends were kind of like regional as well.
Now, she mentioned things like Technetium and OTEC, the cartel that kind of, you know, evolved around the fact that technetium producing moons were, you know, very prevalent in the north. You had an incredible amount of lockdown when they made some other changes. Now, before the change that they made to actual building requirements for certain things in Tech 2, technetium was not necessarily the big thing. There were other moon, you know, things that were more widely used, but they made some changes that created a bottleneck in the north. And I think that they did that thinking that it would create conflict. But what it created instead of conflict was it created a set of people who were willing to share the high profits that could come from the bottleneck. And that's how you ended up with OTEC. But That idea of kind of a, you know, economic foreign policy that related to those people banding together, if only for the you have these moons, we have those, everything else is kind of fair game, but we don't attack those moons, we create a cartel, is something that kind of makes Eve.
Well, and Marshmallow is saying like, well, Morphite was most globally popular in Null when alloys were about. There wasn't really. Maybe I'm remembering wrong. I don't think Morphite really came from alloys, though. Was it Morphite mainly from your Archite, Bistite, Crocore thing, right? Crocite?
No. Morphite was the lone Tech 2 item that came from.
Right. Did that come from alloys?
I'm gonna forget. God damn it! I'm gonna forget the name of the ore. But anyways.
Well, there's Archite, Bistite, and
Megasite and Zidrine came from three things. It basically hot. High Megasite came from Arcanor. Megasite and Zidrine came from Bistot, and Zidrine came from Crocite. And I'm forgetting the thing that Merkoxit. Thank you very much.
Oh, Merkoxit, that's the one. Yeah. Anyways,
she says, but it was the next best to Zidrine Mega. As soon as alloys were removed, those spiked back more globally.
Yeah, I don't
number
think,
one.
I don't think we got
one,
more fight from
this
alloys.
This is one
much.
Of the biggest fallacies that has ever come out of the changes to alloys. This is something we called at the fucking time when people out there were making wrong statements regarding what the changes were going to be. The biggest thing to change from the reduction in alloys was not Megasite and Zidrine. The biggest price changes that were to occur were coming at the low ends of Tritanium and Pyrite and places like that. Because despite what they thought from years earlier, other changes have been made. The biggest things were not high-end materials, because they had rebalanced alloys earlier on to make them more balanced in terms of what you actually need for production and construction of ships and things like that. So actually the biggest percentage price jumps actually came in places like Tritanium and Pyrite, and not in places like Megasite and Zidrine. But there were people out there making false claims to the fact that Megasite and Zidrine were going to like be big boomers, and they were, as long as people were talking. But as soon as the actual change came through, it flipped and went the other way, because alloys were balanced way more than anything else out there towards production.
Yep.
Which required a hell of a lot more Tritanium, Pyrite, Mexilon, things like
that. The smart people, like when the alloys were dissolved of,
I'm taking a shot for remembering those times.
Hold on.
I don't remember shit now.
I'm not pre-pouring right now.
You guys are like talking about really like stuff I don't care about at all, and I just like want to take a shot.
You don't like mining and talk about.
I hate mining. Can I take a shot for all the people who don't like mining?
Yeah. You can.
I'll take a shot because I hate mining. I didn't do mining. My only real experience
taking
mining.
Taking a shot at Tito's Megasite. Megasite juice.
Yeah, the alloys were like the only like, not the only. Here, I've dabbled
juice.
In mining.
There's no alcohol in this.
I've dabbled in mining because it was something new to do, but I didn't really put much time into it. But what was I gonna say? Fuck, I was gonna say something, and I felt it was important. It probably wasn't.
I do want to say this again. I believe that different parts of space.
Oh, I know.
Should be differentiated by like kind of what it is they have as natural resources in order to produce, right? We already know that ratting. Look, you're going to get the same bounties basically, okay, for battleships here versus way the hell over there, okay? Different race of battleships, they all freaking die, pirates get killed, blah blah blah, right? The only thing that really matters in this game is where natural resources are sort of produced. And wow, isn't that kind of a real world sort of idea that not everything is available in the same sort of equality level that it is everywhere else? And those are one of the reasons why you want to be someplace. Maybe, you know what, maybe garistas are easier to kill for some reason or another and still pay the same thing. So therefore, that's kind of like economically a reason why you would want to be there, because you can get more, you know, ISK efficiency per hour or whatnot.
The shitty thing about the drones are like, they weren't omni-tanked, but like most of them were. I think lasers were one of the best things to kill them with, because most of the drone rats I think had an EM hole, but there were some that didn't. So it's like they weren't omni-tanked, but there were a few that were really tough to crack if you went full EM thermal damage. So if you went lasers or like Mjolnir missiles, but. The one thing that I was going to say, and I'm going to say it like while Dirk's talking to Mr. McGurk, was that, oh shit, fuck, I got, oh, hold on, god damn it, I forgot it again. There's the alloys. So the people that held on to these alloys, there were people that, they were banking alloys because they were, it was almost like the technetium trade, back when tech was the bottleneck for T2. You wouldn't just sell all the tech you brought in because it would crash the market. So you held on to it and released it in bottlenecks to keep the price high so you make the most profit, but you bank the extra excesses that you brought in. So people would do with the alloys as well. And once the alloys were gotten rid of,
now,
because they were so mineral efficient, you call them bullshit? Okay. The price is shut up for those alloys, way high.
Well, on alloys, okay. Well, I mean, look, it's the same thing. But
I'm just saying, the people that held on their alloys and then sold them like months later made so much money off those.
If you have somebody who's a thinker out there, okay, they will sit there and they will maybe, okay, if they've got large quantities of anything, they will sit there and like, you know, nipple it out into, you know, into the market in order to like keep prices high, right? But for the average player,
oh, they dump their stuff, but that's right. But the few that held on to their stock when the prices, like when the alloys were pretty much non-existent, and then they were able to distribute those out,
assets. Back in
they could charge way higher and still make money because the people buying them would still get value out of it.
I'm just not even sure if there is a moon out there now that is legitimately a strategic asset. And maybe we will see this with the coming changes, you know, to moon mining, which we think are coming with some of the new arrays. That we will see these things to be strategic assets once again, where they are fought over, you know, for the income. But as far as alloys went, your average guy who was out there, and some people were good. I mean, you know, the Russian renter organizations finally got smart about the fact that, you know what, we need to have like purchasing programs. We want people to be able to go out there, rat, collect their stuff, and have a centralized place locally where they could sell to
at a reasonable price.
Which, if I recall at the time, and CCB Alpha can probably correct me here, but I believe it was like Jitta minus 10% or something like
that. It was cheaper than Jitta, but it was still like
you finding a wormhole or like, you know, transiting it back to a major trade hub to be able to sell it at kind of full Jitta buy price.
If you didn't have your own logistic network, like if you didn't have a jump freighter or some cheap method of transporting to high sec in mass quantity, selling it locally was your best option, and that's what I did, and the prices were good. And so but like you said, like they did it to a point where they could profit off of it while still making the people locally see that as the max profit they could make, and so they would have a guaranteed market.
Says their buyback programs were very advanced for the time. Look, that was one of the very interesting things was how they adapted to kind of the situation as it went on. It was not like that. Believe me, when the drone regions first came out, which I was not actually around for when they first came out, okay, but when I came into the game, the drone regions were, because it was the first place that I ended up going to. They did not have those programs like they ended up evolving to later on. And it was one of the very interesting ways that players kind of adapted and said, hey, you know what? We can make money on this because we have a big freaking, you know, network that we can like, you know, logistics network that we can move this shit back. Let's not, the average freaking player out there, all they want to do is sell their stuff for something that makes them money, and they want to do it locally. So let's put up buy orders. Let's buy this stuff. And then it moved from just buy orders to like, you know, you can go to, I probably still have the bookmark somewhere, you know, for, you know, certain people out there who would buy at, you know, X over Jitta buy, yeah. and you would be like, you know, niggling with, you know, oh, is it actually, oh yes, it is. Geez, look, you know, their price is, you know, 10%, you know, under Jitta buy. I'm willing to live with that. They're not trying to rip me off. And you would like create a contract for it.
There was a corp in, when I was in PNG, there was a corp, I think it was Eagle Eyes Corp. I forget what corp that was, but you remember that guy, right? But Eagle Eyes, his corp had a buy program that basically you would go to their website that they had the program on, and you would basically just type in how much of each.
White Late Night is calling random shot time. You know what? Fuck that.
Yeah.
We don't have that often enough, and I'm giving it to him because it was so random. So it is random shot time. And
yeah.
I'm using my random McNally high drag podcast shot.
I got my high drag shot glass.
Random shot.
But yeah, so Eagle Eyes Corp, he had a thing like you go in there and you basically go through the list. They have a list for each type of alloy, and you type in how much you had, and you'd be like, okay, I got this much of this much of plush, this much of, you know, shiny, this much of whatever the alloys were, and then at the end you'd click a button and it's like, make your contract to this corp for this much ISK. And you would make the contract, and then I'm sure they had a check program at the end where they'd be like, click, see what's in the contract, does it all match up, does the price match up, And it does. It clicks accept. And so it was just a super easy thing. You didn't have to like calculate stuff your own. You just click the button, put in a few numbers, and done.
What's funny about the Russians is the Russians did not have a check program. Okay, what they had was they had, hey,
well,
we're Russians.
Well, this wasn't to the Russians. And, this was to our local corps. But
and if we look back, okay, and find out that you contracted us something that it wasn't, then we're gonna come and cut your nuts off.
I like my nuts, though.
But I like how it works.
I like my nuts a lot.
It works through honesty.
Yeah. When I lived there as a renter, my corp had a similar thing. We used Google Sheets, and the guy that built it set it up that it would pull market prices from JITA, then it would minus 10%. So you went and filled it out with all the minerals and the salvage and the PI, anything you had. You filled it out, then you hit the button at the end, and it would tell you how much to make the contract for, and then you would make it to the corp, and the corp would pay you back.
And that's when they got more advanced. I mean, before that they were before that they were less advanced, but it was definitely one of the drone regions in many ways. Okay, due to the rental empires and what they came up with in terms of kind of intermediary market type things, were some of the first out there to bring this stuff into Eve, and credit to them for doing that. Now, It was not easy going for a lot of those years, out there. But again, you had a differentiating factor that played into the drone regions that was non-existent in a lot of these other places. Yes, other people out there were mining in non-drone region space, okay? But they were much later to the game in terms of what I'll call buyback programs than what they did in this space that was much more specialized to the fact of you were not just shooting getting cheddar. Oh my God, cheddar is so 1989, isn't it? Isn't that a late 80s, early 90s term? I mean, my daughter, if I said cheddar to my daughter right now, she'd be like, that shit you put on enchiladas?
No, she'd probably say no. You don't get it. Still say cheddar.
She wouldn't even know what fucking cheddar is. Cheddar,
here's the thing. Cheddar's
right
OG. Cheddar's OG. She has no business saying cheddar.
She's like NG.
Yeah. People her age say I have no business saying cheddar. People our age, we have the
Gouda
right.
Is a good milk
not
cheese,
not that we say cheddar. We have the right to say cheddar because we OG. And, I'm trying to make it sound
really
important,
OG,
and
though.
I'm not.
Say, if you didn't see Colors when it came out in the movies...
I didn't see Colors.
When you had to actually go to the movies to watch a movie, then you don't have the right to say OG. You're secondary, G. SG.
White light saying my brain is hurting from all this learning. Oh, man.
What the fuck?
The drone region education.
And I'm gonna say this.
Dronification. Right now. That's what it is.
This is one of those
drone regions, and they just started making the drones drop those Nexus chips. And the Nexus chips were used to build the Sisters of Eve ships. They tried to juice it up that way, but it never really panned out.
Oh, yep, charge the juices.
That's absolutely true. And you know the worst part was when they made that change, okay? When they made that change, all of a sudden, our escalation anomalies out in the drone regions went from the normal just a few hops away to 14 jumps, which could have been fucking anywhere. I mean, at that point, you're talking... Holy shit, I have to go out to a place where I have no idea where it is. It might as well be Czechoslovakia. Or the Czech Republic.
I was saying, it's Czech Republic now. It's Czech Republic and Slovakia now.
It may have been fucking Greece.
Well, it might be broke at that point, but...
I'm just saying, it's all of a sudden it was like, wait a minute, hold on.
Yep.
To run this escalation, okay, which will give me... this fucking Nexus One chip or whatever the hell it was at the time, all right? I've now got to go, from 7 jumps to, out to 14 jumps? It was ridiculous. The drone regions, when they made the changes, and this was a change that happened, and it affected all of Eve, okay? It affected all of Eve Nullsec. All right, depending on what your fucking sec status was, depending on how close you were to a low sec... gate or anything like that. They changed all the shit. At one point, Tribute, for all you people out there who don't know, Tribute was one of the fucking capitals of the goddamn world, all right, for the fact that you could earn big megabucks right outside of Empire, basically. And they made a change to the whole sex status thing and, like, the bounties that were paid and whatnot, that totally shit on them. Because their sex status was so low that they got paid shit. But they made a bunch of changes out there. And one of those things affected mining, and it affected, alloy ratting and all this kind of stuff that totally wigged out various parts of the game, including places like Ethereum Reach. Ethereum Reach, which was, yes, it bordered the Forge and, Metropolis Losa, not Metropolis, shit. Anyways, that Minmatar, Losec region, but it was so far away that it was like, holy shit, you're affecting us the same way you are affecting, Tribute. Tribute got screwed out of that, by the way.
All right, back. Sorry, I missed the whole OTEC thing. I'm assuming that was OTEC?
No, I actually skipped over OTEC. Because we talked about OTEC earlier, where it was like, look,
right.
They made changes to blueprint requirements that Tech 2 blueprint requirements that...
That
brought technetium more into vogue than other elements.
Well, and here's the thing that so let's go retro on this. Like, this is like a one.
How fucking retro? When you say retro, Drayden, how fucking retro are you going?
We're going like 2 years back. We're going back to the days of alchemy or whatever they called it.
Oh my god, I totally forgot to bring alchemy into this whole equation.
Well, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, hold on, we're going back to alchemy days. So we're gonna retro this shit up. Now the technetium, like that, I heard when I was.
Can I ask you a side question real quick?
If it's on the side, over here.
Tight sweater, super tight jeans.
Like skinny jeans, like Jay McClane wears in the Division.
Yeah, let's say like Jay McClane skinny jeans.
Jay McClane, the Division skinny jeans.
With shoes that just don't go with the rest of the outfit. Because if there aren't fucking heels at the bottom of that.
Yeah. Well, like, I told him he's now, I was there when he picked those skinny jeans up. And he is now Jay the Fashionista McClane. It's quite known around the Vision universe. Dirk left. But anyway, and here I was like ready to ask a question to Dirk, and now he's gone. So the person I was going to ask a question to is gone. But, all right, so stonewashed jeans. No, not stonewashed. Skinny jeans, man. Like skater jeans. Like.
Do you guys see that the TCU and MTACO is gone? It belongs to NC now.
Well, I assume.
Really?
That's news, but at the same time, not a shock to me. I assume everything in MTECO but the Keepstar is gone for MTECO.
So CO2. Here's the thing about that Keepstar. Last week when we were on this show, the tune was PL gonna kill it. They're not buying it. No one's selling it. PL gonna kill it. This week.
No, I hope so.
Well, I don't know.
That
maybe
wasn't actually
we'll kill
the tune.
It. Maybe we won't.
That was just me saying that. Okay, well, yeah, and literally nobody in fucking PL. Nobody.
You are literally Elise Randolph's right-hand man.
No, literally not, okay? That is what I would
have
preferred.
Oh, I use the left-hand on Elise Randolph, but...
You live in Grath Talkin's beard.
No. My right hand's for Grath, my left hand's for Elise.
Is it warm in there?
It is when I'm done.
Oh.
Like a hot...
Fuck, man. All right, anyway, so okay, Dirk, you're back. Let's move on.
I am back. I'm sorry.
We stopped talking about mining yet.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about. I was talking about mining.
This entire time we have not been talking about mining.
Fucking industrialism.
No, we're not. We're done with mining.
Let's all just agree that the drone region sucks ass, and we don't want to talk about them anymore. Drones suck.
And you know what's sad? This is what disappoints me, Rain. This is what disappoints me. Back in the day of Eve, the people in the drone regions were thought of as the brown people of Eve. And I don't know why you hate
them.
We were the
working Mexicans, not the murky Mexicans.
We were people willing to put in effort to get paid, and all we wanted to do was be part of your clan. And now you're telling me that you don't like to hear about us. You don't want
to
know
about
our history.
I don't like to hear about PvE.
Hugo Chavez Dimitrov wants to know why you don't like him.
You're really bad at poker facing, Dirk. I really just don't like talking about PvE, unless it's something exciting or new. But we're talking about the past, in the past is boring. So move on, Grandpa. Hold on, okay, let's
so
talk about
we're moving. Wait. Rain, you know that learning history will prevent you from making this.
Of Eve.
If you learn history, you won't make the same mistakes again. You won't make the same mistakes
so you won't mind
that we did for making a lot of money for very easy effort. But anyway, so real quick, back to history.
Oh! Number one, Drayden, when you say back to history, what you mean is like, hey, look, you know what? 2 years ago.
Well, no, fuck you. I've been playing for four and a half years.
No, we can't actually move off of this.
We can. Can we?
Well, we
Every time I create show
we
notes.
Can, but there are not many times on this show.
Can we talk about Fozzie yet? Like, we have Avalon and Alpha here. Maybe they can allude to us what Fozzie was talking about.
Well, they just
about.
Work with him.
What?
They don't like
something
him.
Something big happened to Eve. I'm not going to name who it was, but something big happened. You know who you were.
So, Period. There's apparently speculation out there. I saw Fozzie had a tweet. He said, congrats to people who did something big. He left it extremely vague. Nobody really knew what it was. I was kind of like paying attention on my phone at work or Twitter at work. People thought it was the Palatine Keep Star. People thought it was Jove Space. I heard Jove Space was debunked, though. I'm not quite sure what other assumptions it were.
Jove Space is real, as it
Jove Space is real thing. But the jumps within Jove Space were done by someone working. I think it was a GM or an ISD character. So it was not a player discovering Jove Space, which would be really, really big. But a lot of people are still saying, okay, it was the Palatine. Keepstar.
There's no Palatine out there.
There's
How
not
do you
one.
Know?
No,
because there's not.
Because if it was out there, it'd be dead already.
Said there's a Palatine Keepstar.
If there
Come
was,
look at it.
Yeah, if there was one out there,
like
someone would know about it.
People that need
the
to be
first person that de-scanned and saw Palatine, they would
list.
Say,
like,
"Holy
CC'd.
Shit!" Like if I scanned and saw Palatine, and I hadn't heard about it on the news, I would be like, "I'm gonna sell this info."
Can they put it in wormhole space?
No.
Yes.
Of course.
What? Yes.
Yes. And you go to work. Yep.
Absolutely.
Oh shit! That would be man. Imagine that. That would be the best place
oh,
to put it.
Oh shit! Hard Knocks built a Palatine.
Oh
no,
fuck! The first. But
they
yeah,
the first
I mean,
Keepstar.
The information alone. If you're the first person to discover it, you could sell that for like. You could sell that
oh,
for
it
you know,
matter.
Like 10 billion isk or like a 5-inch penis enlargement.
Think...
I mean, whatever you want, it's yours.
Now people are talking about the markets. Like it'd be very obvious if it was a Palatine. But if it's not a Palatine, and it's not the Jove Space thing, then what is
Nobody
it?
Cares.
I don't think he meant something big in the grand scheme of like you know what
let,
we would
let me,
think is
Let me
big.
Go read what he was telling us.
I was
because he
I was
would
almost
not
wondering whether
anything.
Or not he was being kind of like you know tongue in cheek big. Because I saw
Maybe
something
he was
out
trolling.
On Reddit where like you know that you know they showed something with like you know some fucking thorax bullshit.
So Fozzie says the primary point of that tweet was to congratulate the players who did the thing, and I intentionally worded it in a way that would make it unmistakably to them that I'm addressing them. The troll value was just a cherry on top.
And,
he
I
says
think we're
he,
getting trolled right now. I
no,
think that,
he says
I think
he
that
has,
we on this show right now are biting into his troll value.
He says I have no plans to reveal it before the people involved reveal it themselves, since I don't think they'd want me outing them.
Which nothing maybe you know what. And you know what? I'm going to be pissed. Because if I was not on the fucking CC of news being made of a Palatine Keepstar being put up in rage, I'm going to be upset.
You should be.
See, it's less
we all should be. All of us. All of us in the Eve media should be upset that we did not hear about this.
Well, you're hearing about it now.
Maybe we're not.
Maybe
somebody's
you
just
are.
Saying, maybe somebody's just making up fake news and saying that a Palatine Keepstar has been, like, you know, laid out, and that's what Fozzie meant. Or maybe he meant something, like, you know, really ridiculously low scale, and he's like, oh, you big badass is doing that. Maybe somebody fucking jumped a goddamn, Rorqual out there and, you know, with, or an Ibis with a bunch of Titans.
What if?
Maybe
what
somebody
if?
Working at CCP paid off their student loans. Who knows?
Maybe. Maybe CCB Avalon no longer has any student loans.
What if somebody killed a Keepstar already? And no Palatine being placed, but what if somebody else killed a Keepstar?
Literally wouldn't happen without somebody leaking.
Yeah, that would be on the kill boards.
I know.
Only if their APIs. Only if the API is registered, but what if they don't?
Oh, my God. So what you're saying is that there's a super secret group out there that is not linked to API shit.
Some people don't do that. So, like,
and the people would not talk about it anywhere, not even on, like, you know, super secret Reddit.
So think about it like this. So, like, we mentioned wormholes, right? Like, obviously the first Keepstar was built in a wormhole. What if a group built a Keepstar and then they're like, fuck, we don't want this Keepstar, but we don't want to get rid of it. So they either quit the game, they bailed, they couldn't get their emails verified, so they couldn't protect this Keepstar. And then this random, like, bunch of newbies in a wormhole are like, yo, let's kill the Keepstar. It's not defending itself. So they shoot and kill it.
Do we think that based on what Fozzie said, that something big actually happened? Or was he being facetious?
I think it's big because he's obviously trying to credit someone. But I also think it's not as big as Jove Space or a Palatine.
Fozzie tries to be funny. And this is one of the things about Fozzie. Is like, he tries to be funny and, like, make people want to laugh. But, like, I don't think he's got that kind of comedic thing to him. You know what I mean? It's like, I'm saying nothing significant like a Palatine being built happened. But maybe. Certainly, if you weren't notified, get destroyed, it nobody didn't fucking knew about it. Certainly, a Keepstar getting destroyed and nobody knew about it did not happen. Certainly, a bunch of fucking Titans jumping on an Ibis may have actually happened.
Can you see on Z-Kill Keepstar specific kills?
I don't know.
You can.
Yeah, you can pretty much filter everything. Z-Kill's like, you can pretty much Titan hunt with that thing. It's so ridiculous how many search filters and stuff you can change and tweak.
So there was a Keepstar kill, but Eve, I think that news was before it was
Eve
anchored.
Eve on the news, I want to know, are you guys back? Are you guys back writing articles? I see a lot of tweets from you guys, but are you apparently back writing articles?
So, Eve Onion, the guy who tweets, is not the same guy who does the articles. But apparently they're working together. And I don't know who either of them are.
One would hope that they're working together. Oh, shit.
Yeah.
What?
Eve Onion needs
shit. Look at that Rowanin with the Hydra. Rowanin tweeted out, I'm sorry, it was 16 minutes ago, because I don't check my Twitter, like, you know, every minute or whatever here.
Jesus, Dirk.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
He
tweeted
worse
out a picture of, like, our screen while he was watching with a Hydra.
I check my Twitter twice a day.
With a high drag shot glass filled with a clear liquid, which I am going to assume is from the 1.75 liter bottle of Tito's that he had
that
bought earlier.
That is a long stretch.
It is.
Of hyperbole.
I would not bet on that. It is a low margin bet.
Well, it could be water. One does not just simply open a
Rowan
bottle.
A
one does not simply open a 1.75 mil like liter bottle.
Right. You know what? I'm doing a shot
of Tito's.
I'm gonna hold my shot glass.
Although I do want Civ 6 because
and,
Sean Bean's in it.
There you go. Shot.
Shots.
Oh, is it that time?
I have to say.
Yeah, whatever. 10:38
like,
p.m.
Civ 6 is one of those things. Like, the game looks really cool, but Sean Bean's in it, so you have to fucking buy that game.
When does
Sean
he Bean, die?
Sean Bean's in the game?
That's
does
what,
he die in the first, like,
well, no, he's
minutes?
The narrator for Civ 6, and that's what everyone's been saying. They're like, so did your civilization actually get to live to the end of the game because Sean Bean narrates it, or do you just, like, fail, and that's how you win?
That's a fair question.
It kind
of
is.
Since you've brought us to that, I'm going to roll us into, like, you know, a modified, if any of you have any comments regarding TV time.
One does not
kind of
simply
TV time.
Tito.
One does not simply Tito. Exactly. All right. But I'm going to say this. On Sci-Fi, the show Incorporated, okay, there was a part of me watching this first episode from this that made me go, I don't know. Is this such a bad world? It looks, you know, it looks pretty fucking good. Like, you're driving down the highway on your way to the fucking Emerald City, and on both sides of the highway, it looks beautiful. There's this open thing, but it's really like this virtual fucking screen, and on the other side of it are all the slums. And I'm like, that's such a good idea. You should not show the fucking slums when you're on your way to the Emerald City, okay? But and then it's like, but for party time, it's like when you want to go and, like, you know, party hard, you go down to, like, you know, outside the green zone, you go to the red zone, and, like, it's like slumlord Vegas, you know, crazy shit going on there. And it's like, you know, okay, that looks like fun. I'm like, there was a part of me that came away from this first episode thinking, I know that this is supposed to be a dystopian kind of future world, but I recognize that not all of us are going to make it.
Well, now, if you have the HoloLens, they could do this type of thing. You could, like, CGI out the slums when you want. Because that's augmented reality. You can just augment out what you don't want to see.
That is something that I think that we should, like, you know, see more often. I think that, like, you know what? When the news, like, portrays what's going on in bad places out there, it's like they should show an augmented reality kind of, you know, thing where it's like,
Well, because, like, you could go to, like...
Like, downplay the misery.
You could
downplay
set it to, like, misery, utopian. People. You could set it to realism. And then you could set it to despotism. Like, or destitutism, if that's a word.
Oh, look. Roanan put a tweet out.
Tell me to check Twitter. I'm an unbeliever.
People listen to us. People like Roanan. You know, they listen to us.
It's amazing. Like, people actually listen to what we have to say. The fact that any... like. The fact we have listeners is kind of a
still
a
amazes
shock.
Me. Still amazes me. It has amazed me since day one.
There's a pick. I'm gonna relink this too.
Rain. Mining or Trump? Pick a topic.
Trump.
Oh God. Anything
really,
with mining.
Trump. What do you think Trump will do with mining and Eve?
I voted for Trump because
he's gonna make it great.
I think if Trump played Eve, he'd be one of those people in Jita or Amar just talking, not scamming, not doing playing the game, but just talking.
Just
dystopian. That's
local?
A word. That's what I meant to go with.
Yeah, just either like trolling, shit talking, role playing as himself.
He probably tried
to
build a wall around Jita.
I don't know. There's a part of me that sits there and thinks that, you know what? Trump is literally an Eve player because I think that he wants to build the kind of fucked up universe that that we live in here.
He wants
it's
to
owned by
risk.
Corporations. I mean, it's owned by corporations, right? We can sit there and say it's factions, but it's literally owned by the corporations that underlie those factions.
So, if you think Trump played the game, do you think he would try to make a Palatine Keepstar and call it Trump Tower?
Oh, there's no fucking doubt that he would put that shit up.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he would.
We would no longer be, just, like, you know, having any of this shit in fucking Jita. It would be Trump
Yeah,
City.
He's like, oh, that's the best you can get? I'll put one up. I'll find a way. I'll find a way. And if no one wants to sell to me,
Trump would be a major scammer.
I don't think
he'd play
the game.
You don't need to be a scammer when you reach that level.
No, he would buy the game.
Do you think Trump would be one of those people, you know, like in like Korean MMOs, like whales, where they like spend all their money to get the best stuff, but then they're not actually good at the game? Do you
Trump,
think he'd do that?
Trump would be the literal opposite of Scrooge McCabe. Instead of tricking people into doing everything he wants them to do, he would pay them to do everything he wants them to do.
Trump is Caldari, right? He's Caldari. He's
aligned with
Caldari through and through. Amar. He wants to build a wall around the Minmatar and the Galenti.
No. Caldari actually hates Galenti more than Minmatar. Amar hates Minmatar
because they
broke away.
I understand they hate Galenti.
Minmatar is the shame of Amar because they're the slaves that got away. Galenti is the shame of Caldari because freedom is somehow beating capitalism. Well, or capitalism.
What?
Freedom is competing with capitalism. Caldari is about capitalism. Galenti is about freedom. Galenti is about democracy. Minmatar is about freedom, technically, because they were slaves. And Amar is about oppression. Like, if you want to condense all those empires down to one word, Minmatar is freedom. Amar is oppression or domination, one of the two. Galenti is democracy, and Caldari is capitalism.
Freedom, so
that's what I'm saying it is. And my word is law, so that's what it is. Yeah, I said
think
that.
Trump would fly a Raven Navy issue.
I think he would fly a Raven Navy.
He would fly a Raven. He would fly a Raven Navy issue with Raven Navy issue bodyguards.
Leviathan Navy issue.
He would actually
be totally fucking gold.
He would actually be very disappointed if they did not make a Leviathan Navy issue in the game for him. And he would probably just like say, how much money do you want, CCP? Because I need this and fuck you. That's what he'd say.
What faction Titans are out right now. Is it just the Vanquisher?
Yes. Yeah, well, yeah. As far as...
Is the Blood Raider one out, or is that coming?
The other one. I mean, I'm sorry. Yeah, as far as Titans...
Well, they're saying not capitalism, corporatism. I didn't think corporatism was a thing, but isn't it the same thing?
Corporatism. Look, we are going towards the global...
Kaldari is a corporation-based society. I just figured capitalism was that corporation-based society.
And this is exactly what we have built in Eve.
Okay, so corporatism is it? Then that's
we have built this in Eve, okay? Like, believe me, write down, forget what they have pre-programmed in terms of the the NPC factions and things like that. Trump. We have built this in our game.
Trump would deport
the
code.
The players have built this in in our game. And that's what's so fucking cool is it's like, you know what? Eve Online is literally the rise of fucking populism.
Yep.
It's terrible.
Okay, so apparently I'm wrong. Corporatism is a thing, and that is what, I figured capitalism was like the massive influx of corporations taking over, but apparently corporatism is one step above that. So I stand corrected. Corporatism is Kaldari. But I stand behind the rest of my statements.
He would definitely be Kaldari. He would definitely be aligned with the religious Amarian right. Okay.
Not the religious. He would be aligned with the monetary right of
the religious Amarian right. He would build a wall around the Minmatar, and then he would figure out what to do with the goddamn Galenti.
Yep, probably.
And that's exactly how it would roll down. Once you've built a wall, it's like, the wall. Hello.
Imagine if, there was a wall.
Would a wall work in space, though?
If you turn off the...
Oh my god, do you know how big that
wall
would
be? If you turn off the stargates to certain areas? Absolutely. Imagine if you couldn't go to Minmatar space from Amar. Just imagine that.
Oh my
god,
imagine if you couldn't get to Heck.
Yeah, imagine if you had to go to Galenti space and then over to Amar, then over to Minmatar space.
What the heck?
What the heck?
What the heck?
By the way, you know what makes me kind of salty in Eve?
Missiles.
No. Tell us, Ray.
So there have been
ECM?
A few times
people shooting your drones.
That does, but I'm talking about something
I know.
Very specific.
I've seen it.
And petty.
I've seen that happen. Sorry.
So this happened. So I was in a corp over the summer. An alliance, and one
of
the guys there.
Corp?
No, it was Summer Alliance, and one of the guys there was a Nix pilot, and his character's name was Richard Nixon, but he spelled it normally Nixon and not Nyx, and then I realized how much that pisses me off because
that
I didn't
threw you off, didn't it? You're like
yeah, I was like
you
gave
totally
up this grand opportunity
guy.
To spell Nixon. With a Y, and you didn't. And then, but in the past, I have met pilots. So there was a guy who flew a Hell, and he was in a corp called What the Hell, and it was spelled H-E-L. And that's when I realized, because, you see a lot of, capital pilots, or, it's usually, Supers and Titans, and they always have, really cheesy names. Because obviously, you don't just, randomly train your main character into a Super or a Titan. Generally, that's not what people do. They usually have an alt trained specifically for that, or they buy an alt. And so I something that just pisses me off in Eve is if you're going to have an alt or you're going to just have a character that you know is going to be sitting in a super or a titan, why not make that name memorable related to that super or titan? And
Because you don't want to get primaried because of your name.
No, that doesn't even matter. If you're in a fight like that, you should hopefully have facts
poor
on the
Dirk.
Field or
poor
logic.
Poor Dirk has not had a kill or a loss in I don't know how long. Because you know what? I don't want to be the fucking dumbass who gets fucking primaried earlier in the fight.
You'll be fine, Dirk. But no.
No,
no,
he won't. Dirk will die.
No, it's so petty, but
Logi
absolutely
won't save me.
It's just an absolute annoyance when I see somebody with a name Richard Nixon and then they spell it wrong. Or I don't know. If I had a if my character was a capital pilot or a super pilot, it would the name
You'd
would just
be
shit.
Rain chocolate?
No, I'd probably train until I'd be a Ragnarok pilot and call myself Ragnarok Chocolate or something like that. It relates to me flying a capital. Wow.
Why not Chocolate Rot?
Or Rain on the Rag?
Chocolate Rain.
Oh.
No.
So that
Jeremy, what are you doing?
But you know what I mean?
I meant Ragnarok.
But, like, it's stuff like that. And people are just like, nah, man, I'm going to name it, like, Sarah Palin. Because, like, oh, it's so funny. My name
Sarah Palin. Hey, I actually kind of liked I didn't vote for her, but she's from Alaska.
Back when she ran, she was bad.
I used to live in Alaska, like, so I was like, I feel for Palin. We're both Alaskanites.
Well, but no, you're in Idaho, does it make you an Alaskanite?
No, I used to live in Alaska.
Like, okay, like, for a little while, you were like an
like 5 years
teen at that point.
Well, I was, from when I was a year old to when I was 6, I lived in Alaska. So I'm an Alaskanite, I call myself...
From when you were a year old, like, were you born in Alaska?
No, I was born on Travis Air Force Base, that was by Sacramento somewhere in California. But
so, like, you
I think
were
Sacramento
just
is
there
somewhere in California.
Years.
Well, but I'm saying Travis Air Force Base, it's near
so
Sacramento.
Like, you went to Alaskan kindergarten.
But when I was less than a year old, we moved to Anchorage, and I lived in Anchorage until I was almost 6. And then I went to Arizona, which was a big move. Like, when you move from Alaska to Arizona by vehicle and not by plane, that's a big move.
That's a big move. That's a big culture.
And I feel bad for my parents because this... there was 4 kids in my family, and the oldest one was 5 years old. No, 6. So there was a 6-year-old, a 5-year-old, a 3-year-old, and a 10-month-old in the car. Moving.
You get no credit for being a
5,000 miles.
Only being there from age, like, you know, positive 0 to 6. But I do want to throw this out for
did
tomorrow.
I eat any other
apparently,
humans while
apparently,
I was there? What the fuck? Alaska's not a cannibal state. That's like
apparently,
Zimbabwe.
Apparently tomorrow on the Meta show, okay, all of the fucking casino war has been washed over, okay? For those of you out there who were wondering, it's gone. Tomorrow on the fucking Meta show with Mitani and apparently Boat from the picture... we've got Billy from Test, Killer B from PL, Poison Kevin from Northern Coalition, and William Crane from Pandemic Horde. They're going to tell you everything about what's going on with the eviction of what was once known as the traitorous CO2.
Can we talk about more cool things? Like, tomorrow there's a bunch of tournaments going on. I think RVB is doing an event that I'm going to be commentating. Paul's doing an event that there's commentating on. There's, like, this massive carrier event where, like, there's going to be 18 carriers, and you get free destroyers from Trillionaire at 2100, and you can just show up in a destroyer, whore on all the carriers, and just, like, have fun.
I'm doing a quick shot to the Paul Sullivan TNT one-on-one, three-on... Hold on. Is that a round robin three-on-three?
No,
it's a one-on-one double elimination.
Yeah, what he said.
So it's like a round robin of three guys
from
TNT fighting each other.
Yeah, me and Paul will kill each other twice, and that'll be the end of the tournament.
There's not three people.
I did a shot
for it, Derek.
You tell what it is.
Jeremy already said it. It's a 1v1 frigate double elimination tournament. There's like 30 people.
That's tomorrow at 1600 on your channel, Drunk Canadian, right?
Yep. It's gonna be super awesome.
Then on Sunday at 1500 is, I think, round 2 of the RVB event that's going on sometime, I don't know, both Saturday and Sunday. And then at 1930 or 1945, 2100 is the championship series, the EVENT championship, and we're going to be doing the Major League. So it'll be the second round of the Major League, second weekend. And then next weekend, I'll push this again, but they have the finals for both the Minor League and the Major League. And you can always tune in and win stuff. Try to win stuff. I don't know. I commentate on a bunch of things, so I'll be there having fun. But no ESPN music, Paul.
I know. I'm going to be doing it awesome styles.
You're going to have to, like, watch me stream and then just play ESPN music on your own, just for the effect.
Yeah, but if you're streaming at the same time as me, then I probably won't be watching you stream because I'll be busy.
No, I'll be at, like, 2000. Well, how long is your event going to last?
Well, it starts at 1600. It's a 1v1 double elimination. It should be done by 1610.
I know RVB on Sunday.
1610?
I think so, yeah.
Such a dick.
That's Saturday, though, right?
Even you need to ask you, my
right, so room Sunday,
is a closet.
I know it's
not a closet. It's actually, I believe, 9 by 9x14 or something like
so
that.
So it's a walk-in closet.
I want to follow up when I designed it. Article? When I designed it on the original fucking blueprint, it was my computer room. I had this shit fucking insulated in the walls and whatnot, and the ceilings, so that nobody hears my shit fucking upstairs and whatnot. And then my wife decided that she wanted to have a fucking desk in here.
Did you say your kids fucking upstairs?
No, I insulated it so nobody upstairs hears it.
The kids fucking upstairs.
No, so that nobody upstairs hears my fucking voice.
Oh, that too. Now, Dirk, can you pan your camera up? Because we want to see if there's hangers in the closet. Well, there's
no
a light.
Hangers.
Oh,
but do you see where the wall jogs out there? That's where the fucking water pipes come in. So I had to like fucking jog the wall out a little bit.
Oh,
and,
man.
Put some fucking doors on it so the goddamn plumber can get in if like his feeble work does not like, you know, hold.
Does the door lock? Do you have a lock on the door?
No, there's no fucking lock on the fucking door. What
so
is the water going to try?
What you're telling me is
house?
When you pound on the roof and yell labia, someone can just barge in and hit you with a lint roller.
Well, hold on. Yes.
Why a lint roller?
There's a door on the room.
You
although the lock
this
is
on
the
past,
inside.
Paul. This has happened. He literally was like, there was an episode where he was
more Eve history.
He was
where
just
Dirk was hit in the top of the head for yelling.
Yeah,
labia.
Dirk used to sit underneath a staircase and he like hit the staircase and yelled labia, and his wife
not
and his
like
daughter
Harry
came
Potter
down.
Staircase type
and his wife started
like
hitting him in the head
right
with
there.
A lint roller.
Like how many times?
I think it was about 8 times. One short of brain damage, probably, right?
Well, I mean, it is a lint roller. Well, are you saying Dirk's head's
not like
soft?
Consecutive weeks in a row or anything like that, but that night I definitely used the term labia like more than once.
Oh, yeah, you know, you were
loud.
Yelling. Like I almost thought about turning the volume down, but...
I miss those days, bro. I miss those days. Those were different days in this fucking show.
I thought hip-hop might have heard it from my headphones in the next room, so...
Do you remember back before we went on video, we used to like hip hop on. We used to have your
hip hop has
on,
come on video before, like... but yeah. We can get hip hop on.
You know what?
Should I bring hip hop on next
the
week?
The history of not only Eve but the history of this show.
I'll tell hip hop he needs to get on here next week then.
Yeah, really?
Is he gonna
you
come
want,
on cam?
Fuck this shit.
See your
fuck
well, he doesn't have a webcam, so if he wants on cam, he's
we
coming
all need
here.
To smoke pot in this show. That's what we need to do.
Yeah,
no, he
like,
can't. No, hold on.
I don't think Twitch allows that.
Hip-hop back on.
Well, it's
what
not
it?
Allowed
Twitch
in my
allowed.
State, but it's allowed 20 miles.
No, we can't do it on the base
no, you
on
can't
the
do
Eula.
That.
We're going to say Twitch won't know if it's tobacco or not. He's smoking a rolled cigarette.
Oh, my God.
It is a rolled cigarette.
And I'll smoke a rolled cigarette with him. But anyway, no, I'm just saying like he doesn't have a webcam. So it's like if he wants to be on camera, he's coming to my room, which means my headset.
Who
if he
in
wants
this day
to be
and age that is more than like 5 years old doesn't have a fucking webcam.
His computer's like back from the Stone Age. He got his computer brand new when like Diablo 3 is a new game. So like I mean that's
this
like,
is what happens.
That's
when
recent,
not
but that's old.
User versus a
webcam's
pop producer.
Like $20. Just go to Walmart.
Oh, I tell him,
that's
but he has no.
That's democracy
like,
in action.
He has no use to spend a web. Like,
you say that's food out of your kid's mouth?
He has. Well, no, he doesn't have kids.
See, Drayton has a fucking job with his family.
Why you shouldn't have kids?
Apparently, his younger brother is like, I'm unwilling to get up in the morning and work to get a fucking camera.
Well, no, like. He can afford to buy a webcam, but like literally the only use he would ever have for a webcam is to go on this show the once in the fucking long while that he does.
You
so,
should buy it for him so that
the fuck I'm spending your money on that
Lieutenant
fucking
Dan
piece of shit.
Literally just bought you the fucking Division, okay? Like,
wait, you didn't
you,
even buy
you
yourself?
Can get him a goddamn Logitech 1997
typical boy
fucking
gamer
camera.
Fucking
dude,
getting games
I'm not
for
buying
free.
Him a webcam. If he wants a webcam
well,
to come on the show, you can buy a webcam
too.
Give me your old
Paul,
fucking
he's
webcam
not
before
sleep
you,
with
like,
you if you buy
I don't have an old webcam.
Right, yeah.
I have one webcam that I've ever bought, and it's
though.
On. It's looking at me right
oh
now.
My God.
This, you, right there,
okay,
is my one
you webcam. You brown
webcam is my one webcam. Eye contact. I'm gonna hold this, and make people feel
you're
uncomfortable while you talk.
It's really awkward, Drayton. You should stop.
Nope. You're really I can't stop.
Why are you pointing out? What? Oh my God! I love your fucking eye contact, bro.
No. Well,
don't make me come for that ass.
Well, we fixed that, didn't we?
Or on it.
Hold on. Eve Northeast. We'll fix that.
But however, incorporated on fucking sci-fi, I'm going to tell you right now, it is a fucking dystopian world. It is. Okay. But they do have fucking guards up. Like, for you seeing all that dystopian shit, nobody wants to see that stuff. We know it happens out there, okay? It's just like the media. We know it happens. Nobody wants to watch Somalia vids on, like, a fucking daily, you know, grind, right? We just want to know that we go to work in the morning, we come home at night, we give our kids some fucking tofu. It's like, whatever.
I've never had tofu.
We don't want to know how people grow up in other parts of the world.
I eat ramen, like a real American.
Other parts of the world. If you're not fucking goddamn saluting the goddamn flag and not getting thrown in jail for, like, you know, a year, or maybe, like, having your citizenship revoked, it's like, just fucking swear your shit to the flag and don't burn it.
Right. Well, shots not burning flags.
Yeah, don't fucking burn a flag.
Don't burn flags, you fucks.
Hold on. They call it, it's not even about burning a flag. It's just called don't be a dick.
Yeah.
And if you're not a dick, you won't get fucking thrown in jail
don't
or lose
be
your citizenship.
A deplorable.
Shots for not being a dick.
No
dick shots.
Shots
for not being a dick. I feel like for that entire statement, I will literally have, like, created my birth in hell.
Whatever. Say no dick shots? Dark.
No, I'm definitely going to fucking hell for that. This guy who's fucking president is a goddamn fucking schwatze. He totally fucking is.
A schwatze? Man, I don't know Jewish. Wait, was that?
Yeah, what's a schwatze?
We should all fucking demand more. We totally fucking should. You know what? Fucking hail to the fucking chief, whatever.
What the fuck? People say I'm spice melange. I don't know that. Like, I'm mangy.
That is a good fucking show. And by the way, in case nobody was noticing, fucking Vikings is back.
Is it back?
It is back. It is
someone
back.
Like everyone said,
like,
it started on
the
30th, and then I talked to Jay, and he's like, I looked everywhere for it, and I couldn't find it. So he couldn't find it.
Is
anyone watching
sure
The Crown?
Fucking back.
What the fuck is The Crown?
It's about the Queen.
Oh my God! You can totally get that on fucking Netflix.
Netflix, yeah.
Is that? Oh, hold on. You can't be like, I'm watching The Crown and not say, like, I'm totally binging The Crown on Netflix.
If no one else is watching The Crown, I'm not going to talk anymore about The Crown. I'm not going to push the Queen on fucking the US of A.
You
guys
get
don't
out
like
here
her. That's fine. That's cool. I like
talk.
The Queen. Reference the flag.
The Queen is whatever. Actually a good show. However, I'm totally going to fucking, like, you know, forget the fucking name of it. It is a it is an Australian-based show. There's actually a couple Australian-based shows that I'm watching right now. One, it was only 6 episodes long, so it's like, fuck, you might want to wait until season 2 comes out and just, like, fucking binge, hopefully, what is 18 seasons or something like that at the time. You should watch that, which I totally didn't give a name for. And the other one is about this, like, the people that are Harry's. Fuck, I need to go over to my fucking DVR and, like, figure out what the name of this fucking show is. I think I tweeted it out the other day. It's kind of fucking cool. Like, you know, they're, like, registering who are, like, these subhumans. Which I find to be interesting. I find to be that whole fucking concept of, like, what people
like
think
Star
are
Trek?
Subhuman. No, it's not Star Trek.
Everything's subhuman there.
But, the shit that's apparently coming out of fucking Australian TV, ABC Broadcasting over there, and onto Netflix is totally a, watch who you're fucking locking up kind of a Clever Man. Clever Man, thank you, Rannon. And the first one was Glitch. Thank you, Clever Man. I'm sorry. Thank you, Rannon. Holy shit.
Thank you, Clever Man.
Wait, hold on, time out.
He didn't say it first. Danica did.
This is what's bullshit. Do not use a level to find out how fucking drunk you are, because even when you're fucking drunk, you can find level.
Wait, really?
Yeah, no, I literally just found level. Watch.
Oh my god. How is Dirk drunker than I am?
He's drinking faster.
skill.
We've been doing the same amount of shots.
No, I am totally have a you? Fucking pussy when
I
it
think
comes
you
to
missed
like,
one.
Drinking,
so you're like, one behind, I think. Or, well, hold on.
But anyways,
here's
I
the
was
thing.
Totally
you're
just trying
you're
to cover
even
this
on shots,
but
you're like eight cigarettes behind. So
I was,
catch up.
I was totally just trying to cover this until what I believe to be Paul Sullivan coming up next. Are you not coming up next?
Should be.
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah.
So, what I want to say is this. Look, I know that tonight on the fucking Open Comm show, we did not bring you all the insight that you're normally accustomed to. However, tomorrow morning on the Matania.com, we've got Matterall and the fucking gang from the European time zone, which is like 9 a.m. U.S. time, and nobody here wakes up on a Saturday in fucking 9 a.m. U.S. time zone other than Matterall, who lives on the fucking left coast.
Right.
And some Europeans. But that being said, they're coming up tomorrow with a show that I think actually has some fucking merit to it, and I can't remember who's actually on it, but it's Talking in Stations, and you all know that you think highly of Talking in Stations as opposed to us, who are like a Friday night closeout. And then later on in the day, you've got the entire tribute fucking war story from the Meta Show. The Meta Show, is that what it's called? Is it still called that? The Mitanni Show? The Mitanni yeah. Factor?
The Meta Show.
Still the Meta Show.
It should totally be the Mitanni Factor. But whatever. Anyways, I only threw that out there tonight because, like, I don't know. I totally didn't have anything to say. Drunk Canadian, you ready to take over?
Almost. I'm trying to do this thing in the division.
Oh, whoa. Hold on.
You've been playing a division for a year now.
Paul, you playing Division for your stream?
Yeah.
Can you invite me?
I don't know. Can I?
What level are you?
Oh, wow. I'm such a dick.
Oh,
I'm
wow.
I'm maxed out, and I'm on tier 5.
You know what? What level?
Just
to fucking Jamie 30. Playing in the fucking head.
Are you willing to accept a level 15? No, 16.
Yeah, I don't give a shit, man.
Oh, man. I will throw you turrets and hide behind you. That's what I'll do.
Yeah, whatever.
How is that show not the Mitanni Factor? Seriously.
What?
So tomorrow on the Mitanni Factor, you'll find out how NCDOT is buying the Keepstar from CO2 and not destroying it.
Wait, say again, LB?
I think NCDOT's going to buy that Keepstar from CO2. I don't think
it's so dumb. Kill it! Kill it, you fucking... hold on, no. I won't rant. No, hold on.
Kill one of these motherfuckers.
Hold on. I will.
To drop anything on it to kill it.
I will rant. Hold on.
Buy it from them.
I will rant. I will rant. Here we go. Here's my rant. I'm a broke bitch. But you rich motherfuckers, kill that goddamn Keepstar because you have all the fucking money in the world. You have no reason not kill that shit. You have all the capitals to kill that shit. Fucking take that shit down, you bitch motherfuckers. And I'm looking at you, Grath. Yell at me if you want to. I know you want to. I love you. But yell at me, Grath, Elise, Doom Chinchilla, fucking, now I'm gonna be a dick for getting your name.
Other
you fucking
PO guy?
Chivalry playing motherfucker, Jeff Rader. That's what I'm thinking of. Okay, here's my rant. Okay, now I'm even worse for like forgetting his name on the rant. But like, fuck you guys. You have all the money in the world. You want to be the first to kill a Keepstar? Kill that shit. Don't be a bitch. Drop that shit. Fuck CO2. Kill it.
They need their supers to go over to Vale of the Silent and get rid of Tess, so they're not going to waste them on the fucking Keepstar. They're going to buy the Keepstar instead.
All right, there's my rant.
That's the first time I've seen Drayden, like, get angry. Later.
No, I'm not angry. I was just hyped. That's not angry.
Later,
that's hyped.
Bitches.
That's hyped.
How you ended, Drayden.
And I'm gonna hear some backlash from that because probably Jeff Rader for saying, you don't even know who the fuck I am, right?
He's Canadian. It's like semi-Idahoan.
We don't remember names in Idaho.
I apologize for not being more well-known.
Is it over?
Yeah, it's over. All right, we're going to close it.
Are you going to play this with me, or what's going on?
Yeah, I'll play with you. Hold on. Look for just Drayden Trevier, no spaces. Two R's and Trevier.
How do I open up the fucking thing in this?
I'll be in team, so I'll figure it out with you. But anyway, we're going to close the stream. All right, peace.